10.
Testing 1, 2, 3. Testing 1, 2, 3.
We are testing
from the Mueller Stadium on Blue Jay Field.
Just wait. Testing the second microphone for live stream broadcast here at Westminster College.
Today's typical college student is no longer the recent high school graduate. Almost half of all college students in the United States are age 24 or older, and they have busy lifestyles. They have families, they work part-time jobs or full-time jobs, and they want to earn a college degree. As you can imagine, the traditional college experience just doesn't work for them. Westminster College has a rich history of excellence in cultivating leaders. And now, we can take that experience beyond our campus. We're proud to announce the launch of Westminster Online. It's designed to be flexible and to meet your needs. This program runs in back-to-back 7-week sessions, so you can finish your degree faster. It's 100% online, so you can attend class on your schedule. You can choose to major in either business administration, organizational leadership, or in psychology. Westminster Online is affordable, and if you need to pause your studies, because life happens, you can do that. You're able to sit out a session and then come back when you're ready. Check out our website at wcmo.edu to learn more.
The way we consume digital media in our world is constantly changing. The way we learn about it needs to change at that same pace. At Westminster College, we're putting you at the forefront of this interdisciplinary research by letting you experience firsthand some of these changes so you'll be better prepared to create it yourself when you leave our campus. In our labs, you'll experience cutting-edge technologies that will prepare you for a career in whichever sector of digital media that you're comfortable. You won't just hear about digital media, you'll experience it yourself.
Museum Studies at Westminster is a program where students create and curate exhibitions, design programs, ask challenging questions, and above all, blend history, heritage, and culture in a way that informs and inspires. We invite you to join us at Westminster and be a part of history in a way that not only preserves the past, but through the power of museums, helps to build a better future.
Museums allow us to celebrate humanity's soaring achievements while also providing lessons on how to avoid the mistakes of our past. They can also amplify the voices of underrepresented groups while bringing economic uplift to communities. We invite you to explore this world while finding a rewarding career by becoming a Museum Studies major at Westminster College.
Financial planning is one of those careers that lures you with your own professional accomplishment as well as a deep mental satisfaction from helping your clients directly. For example, as a financial planning professional, you'll help your clients in developing such personal financial plans as estate planning and retirement planning. Our curriculum also aligns well with the CFP Board's learning outcomes. Here at Westminster, you can also pursue a dual degree in financial planning and finance to further your career.
Today's typical college student.
Okay, we got our touchdown. We're good. Bro, Ohio State is dogging on Arkansas State right now. See him yet. What time does it say that they're going to have?
5 minutes more. on live.
Thank you.
Good afternoon and welcome to Blue Jay Stadium in Fulton, Missouri, as we're getting set for the home opener for the Westminster Blue Jays as they host the Iowa Wesleyan Tigers out of Mount Pleasant, Iowa, making about a 2.5-hour trip to mid-Missouri as this is a non-conference matchup. I'm Aaron Mosher with Hunter Mololand, and it's a great evening, a great day, great sunshine, great weather for football today.
It's a beautiful day for some football. Very few clouds in the sky, and I know both teams are ready to get after it and get this home opener underway for the Blue Jays.
Both teams looking for their first victory of the season. Westminster traveled to Knox College and fell 26-0, and they're trying to get back in the win column. Iowa Wesleyan 0-2 on the year after falling to Tabor, and then in a 4-overtime thriller to Mo Baptist last week. They lost by 2 after a 2-point conversion. As the ball is set on the tee, and Iowa Wesleyan will be moving right to left. They are in their powder blues. Iowa Wesleyan in their road whites. Dawson Brandt getting ready to kick us off. Tyler Ball and Damian Tantalus sit ready to return for the Tigers. Make that Jaden Harris instead of Tyler Ball. I'll make that Tyler Ball returning it from the 20-yard line. Takes it near side down the hash to the 30. And that's where he's met by a pair of Blue Jays. And Iowa Wesleyan will take over. Iowa Wesleyan led by Mitch Daniels in his third season at the helm. They love to run the air raid. It's been a historic part of this program, going all the way back to Mike Leach. And they're going to pass it a whole lot today, averaging 321.5 passing yards per game. And the man getting ready to take the snap is Zach Chevalier, the freshman. He replaces Gavin Esquivel, who's the backup now. He's more experienced, but Chevalier getting the start here today.
Blue Jays with a one high safety.
Three wide receivers. And Chevalier takes the snap, hands it off up the middle, and gaining almost a first down on the first play to the 39-yard line of the right hash. Three wide receivers once again. Jaden Harris on the near side by himself, as referees will blow it dead. That was Cameron Cole on the run on that first play. They've been running a lot of different running backs for this Iowa Wesleyan team. They don't run it a whole lot, but they like to spread out the carries.
Bit of confusion with the chain gang. Looks like the chain gang was a yard too long.
Cam Cole still in the game. Chevalier in the shotgun. Cole next to him. Two on the far side, one wide receiver on the near side. Handoff up the middle and stopped, but rumbling forward is Cam Cole, as they did award a first down off that first play, and another first down carry for Cole gains them about 4 yards. 13:09 left to play in the first quarter. Still three wide receivers. Fake the handoff, throw to the far side. Caught, no, dropped by Harris. Make that Tyler Ball with the drop. That's a third down now for Iowa Wesleyan. Jalen White, the running back, is now replaced. Stafford Lewis, the senior, checks into the game. Third down and 6 for Iowa Wesleyan, and
more confusion.
Another timeout from this reffing crew. Umpire today, David Burkhart. Make that Jaron LeGrant. Head referee, David Burkhart. Ball in the 44, third down and six on the near side. Chevalier in the shotgun as we reset the game clock to 12:34. Make that 12:44.
Big third down for the Blue Jays here.
Now can you get off the field and stop the Tigers on their own side of the field? Sam McWilliams on the near side. He's defended tightly. Now a throw to the far side and over the head of his intended wide receiver is Chevalier. Looking for Jamarian Ferguson, the freshman. And I make that Westminster forces a punt. Chevalier looked to the near side, but great job off the line by Robert Anthony on the press.
This is Logan Blicken.
And the punt sent away by Mask Paskowitz, and a fair caught at the 20-yard line by Peyton James. So Westminster takes over. Again, the score 26-0 last week. Not a whole lot of offensive success. Hunter, what can they do better today to try to get some momentum going early?
Well, they got to pick up first downs. They only picked up one first down in the entire first half. They got to move the football, keep the defense off the field. Out of 140 snaps last week, defense played about 120 of them. So the key play here is to move the football, keep your defense off the field, keep their offense off the field. We know how dangerous Iowa Wesleyan's offense is.
Bryce Westerfield takes the snap, hands it off to his running back. A big hit from the Tigers linebacker. Taylor Dobbins on the carry. He'll be the bell cow most often on this Westminster offense. All UMAC last season, over 1,000 yards rushing. Second down, 8 yards to go with 12:08 in the first quarter. Westerfield in the pistol. Dobbins behind him. Four wide receivers, three in the bunch to the far side next to the offensive line. Westerfield a pitch down the right hash, and Dobbins is stopped after a short gain. An early third down for Westminster. They were just 2 for 13. Last week on third down conversions.
Here's the big play here in the first quarter is picking up this third down and keeping your defense off the field. The defense did a great job of stopping Iowa Wesleyan's offense on that opening drive. You're looking for your offense to pick you up here and get down the field and put some points on the board.
Four wide receivers for Westminster. Jabin Shockley on the near side with Peyton James. Westerfield the shotgun, Dobbins to his left, takes the snap, rolls to his left, looking downfield, he doesn't have anything, and he is dropped at the 20-yard line by the Iowa Wesleyan defense. That's Moses Eason, the 5'9 junior, making that stop. Stops by both defenses early on in Fulton, Missouri, no score, 10:40. And ticking in the first quarter as an early punt upcoming for Westminster. It was a busy day for Dawson Brandt against Knox College. Had 9 punts for 301 yards. They have timeout on the field. And we'll take a timeout with them. No score.
Museums allow us to celebrate humanity's soaring achievements while also providing lessons on how to avoid the mistakes of our past. They can also amplify the voices of underrepresented groups while bringing economic uplift to communities. We invite you to explore this world while finding a rewarding career by becoming a Museum Studies major at Westminster College.
The way we consume digital media in our world is constantly changing. The way we learn about it needs to change at that same pace. At Westminster College, we're putting you.
Both teams return to the field after that timeout. And Dawson Brandt stands ready at his 9-yard line. Back to receive the punt, it's Tyler Ball. On the near side hash, good snap, end over end punt. Ball receives it at the 50-yard line, and he is dropped. A big hit from the Westminster coverage team. And Iowa Wesleyan will stay on their own half of the field. Mason Kirkweg, the 6-foot freshman out of Eldon, Missouri, with a big time stop to energize this Westminster defense as they take the field. Once again, after keeping the Tigers on their own side on their first drive. Had several stoppages to begin this game from the referees. I think trying to get the chains right, trying to get the game clock right. Nine minutes, 56 seconds put back on the clock in the first quarter. Nobody has found a score yet.
This will be a long game if they keep the scoreboard like this. 96 minutes. Ah, there we go.
Now we're good to go. Chevalier steps back from his offensive line. He stands at the 45. First down and 10, Cam Cole to his left. Hand off to Cole up the middle, and he's being dragged. He rumbles through a few Westminster defenders. He gains about 5 yards.
His Iowa Wesleyan running backs are persistent. They get a lot of yards after contact.
Cam Cole, a strong guy, has got the handoff this time, throw to the near side, and a drop by the Iowa Wesleyan wide receiver, Say McWilliams, the 6'5 sophomore. And another third down for Iowa Wesleyan. Coming into today, they were 8 for 35 on third down, so something both teams need to improve on today. Third down and 4 to go in the midfield on the Blue Jay logo. Chevalier stands at the 50. Four wide receivers, trips to the far side. Chevalier looks near side, and it's tipped up and almost intercepted by Westminster. Cameron Offerman, the sophomore, got his hands on it.
That's classic tip drill. They work on that at defensive practice every day. Those are the moments that you live for as a linebacker. Tip that ball up, get your safeties and cornerbacks an interception.
Chevalier has looked to McWilliams multiple times today and unable to make a connection. And another punt upcoming for Iowa Wesleyan. Paskowitz, the junior, puts his foot into it, end over end, and it plops at the 8, rolls, and the coverage team can't hang on to it before it runs into the end zone, and Westminster will get a fresh set of downs. We'll start at the 25-yard line. Three and out last time. Can they pick up a first down? Try to give Bryce Westerfield some momentum in his freshman campaign. Taylor Dobbins returns. He's behind Westerfield in the pistol. Three and a bunch to the near side. One alone on the far side for Westminster. Westerfield, handoff to Dobbins. Dobbins trying to go off tackle, but he's met by the contain. Gained maybe a yard. Second down and 9 to go from the 21. Under 9 to play in the first quarter. Still no score in Fulton, Missouri. Jabin Shockley alone on the near side, a bunch to the far side. Dobbins behind Westerfield. Safety's playing up at the 30-yard line for Iowa Wesley. Handoff Dobbins to the left, off the left tackle, and he is met by Major Nycomb, the linebacker, who after the first week was the defensive player of the week in the North Star Athletics Association. He had 15 tackles in that opener against Tabor. And another third down for Westminster. Third down and 9 to go. Westerfield just 12 passes in that opener, 5 for 12. Again, Westminster pick up their first down of the day. Third down and 9, under 8 to play in the first quarter. One tight end lined up to the right. Three wide receivers, Dobbins the left. Option play, Westerfield, he keeps it himself, and there is just nothing on the near side. And another three and out for the Blue Jays offense.
Starting to see the struggle from last week return again today. Moving the football early in the game.
Just can't pick up any yards to get manageable third downs.
No, you can't. Last week, Dobbins only had 6 yards on 10 rushing attempts. None of the running backs had much better.
Brandt with the punt. It's a line drive. Lands at the 42 of the Blue Jays and takes a roll to the 49 on that side of the field. That's where Iowa Wesleyan will take over. 7:07 left in the first quarter of play.
Offenses haven't gotten anything going today.
No, and it's been some incompletions out of Iowa Wesleyan, and neither team can get any momentum going. Cam Cole returns at running back for the Tigers. Say McWilliams on the near side. At midfield is where the Iowa Wesleyan stands. First down and 10. Four wide receivers trips to the far side. Chevalier takes the snap, looks near side, throws it looking for McWilliams. High points the ball and makes the grab. Makes the grab over Robert Anthony at the 20-yard line. And Iowa Wesleyan has some momentum. Just 2 yards away from the red zone. They hurry to the line. Three wide receivers to the near side in the trips. Jamarian Ferguson alone on the far side. Cam Cole to the right of Chevalier. On the near side hash. Drop back from Chevalier. Looking over the middle. It's complete and caught. Touchdown, Iowa Wesleyan. Jamarian Ferguson. One-on-one coverage. And he burns Blicken for the first touchdown of the day.
Quarterbacks love those crossing routes. They love when that receiver's coming right back into their line of sight. They don't have to peel their eyes away from the pressure coming up from the rush.
Beautiful ball by Chevalier to connect with Ferguson, and that's the third touchdown of the season for Chevalier. Lucas Mosqueda is 2 for 3 on the season on field goals, but this is an extra point. With 6:27 left in the first quarter, kick is up, and it is no good. Mosqueda misses the extra point, so Iowa Wesleyan sits at 6-0, leading Westminster. Maybe had a little trouble with the snap, and Iowa Wesleyan was late trying to get on the special teams unit. Iowa Wesleyan with the lead, 6-0. They finished 20-21, 2-9, and 1-5 in the North Star Athletics Association. They were picked to finish last once again in the conference by the coaches' poll. Mitch Daniels trying to get this program with some positive momentum here in 2022. Mosqueda lines up to kick us away. 6:27, Iowa Wesleyan leads 6-0.
Only one back to return for the Blue Jays.
End over end kick, and it is returned by the Blue Jay down the far side hash, and he doesn't get much. Gets to the 25. That was Shelby Pitson-Barger for the Blue Jays. It's on that reset, still looking for that first down today. Westerfield in the pistol. One running back behind him. Four wide receivers. Once again, Shockley to the near side alone. Jaheim Hampton lines up opposite him. Westerfield looks to his right, and it's looking for clap saddle, and just threw it over his head.
Clap saddle comes down with that. That's the first down for the Blue Jays today.
It's a good look from Westerfield. Just needs to get the ball down. Brings up second down from the 25 on the far hash. Jordan Kern in the backfield behind Westerfield. Same formation, three and a bunch far side. Shockley alone on the near side. Two safeties for Iowa Wesleyan. They're rushing four. Second down and 10, Westerfield takes the snap, looks to his near side, and another misconnection, looking for Shockley, and some miscommunication maybe on the route.
Looked like Shockley was going for a crossing route or an in route, or maybe a deeper hitch, and Westerfield was looking for a little bit of a shorter hitch, maybe something that try and drop that cornerback off since he was a man. Big third and 10 here for the Blue Jays.
Dylan Clap Saddle here the near side. Four wide receivers make that three. Westerfield takes a snap, looks to the near side, tries to roll away from pressure, but he is dropped by Moses Eason. Once again, second sack of the day for number 93 of Iowa Wesleyan. And Westminster just can't get anything positive going offensively. Six to nothing, Iowa Wesleyan leads. 5:43 left in the first quarter as Brandt returns for his third punt of the day. Tyler Ball stands at the 45-yard line at the edge of the Blue Jay logo. In the end, at the goal line stands Brandt. He takes the snap in. High end-over-end punt. Ball takes it. Runs it to the 40, to the 35, down the near side, 30, 25, and he's pushed out of bounds by Pitson-Berger. And Iowa Wesleyan set up with good field position once again.
Yes, they are. They're based off their last two passes, they're one play away from the end zone. Big air raid team. Seen a lot of it already. A couple drops, but when they connect, it's usually a big play, usually resulting in a first down.
At the 22-yard line is where Iowa Wesleyan takes over. First down and 10, Cam Cole to the right of Chevalier. Three wide receivers in the trips to the near side. Jaden Harris closest to the sideline. One alone on the far side. Looking for Tyler Ball. To the end zone, and the catch is made. Touchdown, Iowa Wesleyan. What a grab by Tyler Ball over two Blue Jays.
It's a great throw. I'm putting that right where only my receiver can get it. Nobody else can. And all he had to do was try and keep the feet in bounds. And we see what happens when Iowa Wesleyan gets some momentum in the air.
One play drive. Chevalier drops a dime to Ball, and he makes a great catch at the sideline. Mosqueda tries again with the extra point. And this time it is through, and so Iowa Wesleyan takes a 13-0 lead.
I think he just smoked a moving car.
Yeah, all those cars lined up past the end zone.
Somebody was driving down the road. I don't think they're expecting a football to come through their window.
Maybe need a big sign, watch out.
It's like a baseball game. Drive at your own risk.
Absolutely. .452 in the first quarter.
It's a big defensive drive for Iowa Wesleyan. If they keep the Blue Jay offense going three and out, they can get the ball back in around the same positioning that they had the ball the last two times, and we see what happens when they get good field position. They're able to spread it out and cause a problem for the opposing defense. It's also a big drive for the Blue Jays. They need to snuff out some momentum that Iowa Wesleyan has.
They got to get some kind of run game going. That's
got to move the football.
Got to get some push. Mosqueda kicks it off from the 35. Pitts and Barger back to receive. Takes it at his 10-yard line up the middle of the field. Veers left. Here he comes on the near side to the 25-30. Has some room to the 40, and he's dragged down. A really nice return and gives Westminster their best field position all day.
It's a great return by Pitts and Barger. It's the biggest play we've seen from Westminster so far, and I believe that they will use that to their advantage, maybe have a little bit more space. They don't have to worry about getting dropped in the end zone like they have on the last two drives.
Westminster has the ball marked at the 39-yard line on the near side hash. Dobbins behind Westerfield. A lot more tight ends in this time. Hand off to Dobbins, up the middle, down the hash, and he picks up 2 yards.
Might start to see more of this formation as we move along throughout this game. Westminster's got a new offensive coaching staff, and they've implemented the triple option offense. And I believe that we'll see more of that as the game goes on. Maybe the passing offense is more of we're deep in our own territory.
Dante Billups in the game. Wyatt Robinson in as well. Westerfield takes a snap on the hash. Hands it off to Dobbins, and there's not a lot of room. Maybe gained a half yard. .348 and ticking in the first quarter. Iowa Wesleyan leads 13-0 over Westminster. Westminster possession. Second down, 7 to go from the 42-yard line. Make that third down and 7. Westminster still looking to pick up their first down of the game.
They're also looking to get into Iowa Wesleyan territory on this play.
Aaron Hurt alone to the near side. Still in that triple option formation. Westerfield takes a snap, drops back, fires to the far side, looking for clap saddle and more miscommunication between him and his wide receiver, as Westminster just can't get anything going offensively.
Westerfield took a big hit on that throw. He's laying down for a minute, maybe just recuperating from the hit. He seems to be fine, though. He's getting off the field on his own power.
Another three and out from the Blue Jays, trailing 13-0, 3:10 in the first quarter. And at the 42-yard line, Dawson Brandt getting ready to punt once again. Tyler Ball stands at the 26-yard line. Line drive, punt tailing away from Ball and bounces out of bounds inside the 20. Not too bad from Dawson Brandt. They mark it at the 18 or 19-yard line on the near side. So Iowa Wesleyan, their last two drives have been touchdowns, one to Ferguson, one to Ball. Two touchdown passes on the day for Zach Chevalier. out of Los Angeles Valley College. He came in today with 250 yards, 20 for 45. And the shotgun, Jaden Harris to the near side for Iowa Wesleyan. Chevalier takes the snap, fakes the handoff. Looking down the field, he throws it there, and it's broken up. Looking, and Dylan Farrell with the breakup.
It's a great lurk by Farrell. He was off the receiver just enough to make the quarterback think that he was open and he could hit him, and came up right when the ball was meeting the receiver and was able to knock it away.
Four wide receivers, Chevalier in the shotgun, Cole to his right, McMillan to the near side. Takes the snap, throws it on the slant, looking for McMillan, and another tip drill that could have been intercepted, but safely for Iowa Wesleyan, it falls incomplete, bringing up a third down and 10.
Almost need to, for those tips to work, you almost need to get it up like a volleyball set. If it has too much downward arc on it when it comes off the hands of the receiver or the cornerback, it's usually going to fall incomplete.
13-0, Tigers lead. They have the ball at the 19-yard line on the near side hash. Third down and 10. Shotgun, three wide receivers. Chevalier takes it at his chest, throws it, and it's intercepted! Intercepted by Offerman. And Westminster takes over in Iowa Wesleyan territory. Just a poor decision by Chevalier. And a big time momentum shift play right there from the Westminster defense.
That's the second week in a row Cam Offerman's came away with an interception.
The sophomore makes a big time play.
It's a huge play for Westminster. Puts them in great field position, gets them to get ready. Maybe a little momentum shift here. Maybe we'll start to see Westminster's offense move the football a little bit.
That's the hope. Got to take advantage of field position like this. So Westerfield in the offense return, Wyatt Robinson on the left wing in this triple option. Shockley alone on the near side, three wide receivers. Jordan Kern behind Westerfield. Hand off to Kern, takes it off tackle, stiff arms a man, drives through another, looking for the first down, drives through more Iowa Wesleyan defenders, and he does have the first down. What an effort from Jordan Kern. And they'll mark him inches short.
I believe the
close near side.
Yeah, the near side refs are signaling for a first down.
How about that as an effort to get the first down of the day for the Westminster offense?
That's how you got to pick it up, yards after contact.
He was a leading rusher against Knox College, 67 yards on 10 rushes. Gets the handoff again, looking around the same area, but this time the Tigers' defense swarms at the 19-yard line. So that'll bring up second down and maybe 7 to go. Westminster finally with some offensive momentum. Jordan Kern had the 42-yard run last week. 1:38 and ticking. Iowa Wesleyan with the lead, 13-0 in the first quarter. Westerfield in the pistol. Taylor Dobbins back in the game. Robinson and Billups in as wingbacks. Hand off to Dobbins up the middle, trying to follow his offensive lineman. But nothing going on that run.
It's a great job by the Iowa Wesleyan defense to swarm the ball carrier and get a team tackle.
Overall been a good defensive performance from this defense.
A little bit of pursuit drill there.
Under a minute to play in the first quarter, third down and 7. Both of these teams looking for their first win of the season. And the home opener for Westminster. Picked to finish 5th in the UMAC in the coaches' poll. Westerfield in the pistol.
Looks to be a one-on-one here on the near side.
Fakes the handoff, rolls to his left, trying to get evade a defender, and he barely gets the ball away. And look who it is again. Moses Eason has been the kryptonite today to this Westminster passing game.
When he doesn't come away with a sack, he comes away with a quarterback pressure or a quarterback hit. He's playing very, very good defensive football.
Decision time for Westminster. And I think they're going to go for it.
They are. That's a big fourth down for Westminster.
They were 0 for 2 on fourth down last week against Knox. Four wide receivers in the formation for the Blue Jays. Dobbins behind Westerfield. Shockley and Campbell to the near side. 30 seconds to play in the first quarter. Westerfield takes a snap, looks to the far side, and it's intercepted. Intercepted by the Tigers, running down the far side to the 35. Makes a man miss and then is brought down. Joseph Pace, the sophomore, picks off Westerfield and resets this game for Iowa Wesleyan.
It's not the ideal answer for a turnover is to turn the ball back over yourselves.
So Joseph Pace gives back the ball to the Iowa Wesleyan offense. Westerfield just trying to make something happen on fourth down. And Westminster can't get on the scoreboard yet. 13-0, Iowa Wesleyan leads. 20 seconds left in the first quarter. Chevalier and Cam Cole returns. Three wide receivers, one on the near side, two to the far side. Four rushes for Westminster. As Cam Cole is wrapped up in the backfield, he loses about one. Garrett Berger makes the stop for the Westminster defense. As that will end the first quarter, all Iowa Wesleyan 13-0, they lead. As we will take a break, you are watching Iowa Wesleyan football in Fulton, Missouri.
Today's typical college student is no longer the recent high school graduate. Almost half of all college students in the United States are age 24 or older, and they have busy lifestyles. They have families, they work part-time jobs or full-time jobs, and they want to earn a college degree. As you could imagine, the traditional college experience just doesn't work for them. Westminster College has a rich history of excellence in cultivating leaders. And now we can take that experience beyond our campus. We're proud to announce the launch of Westminster Online. It's designed to be flexible and to meet your needs. This program runs in back-to-back 7.
Iowa Wesleyan on the near side hash at the 39-yard line. Second down and 10 to go for the Tigers to start the second quarter of play. Leading 13-0 over Westminster, Aaron Mosier and Hunter Molahan here with you from Fulton, Missouri. As you see across the field working on the new press box here at Blue Jay Stadium. Chevalier in the shotgun, Cole to his left, takes the snap. Throws it over the middle, complete, has his man, Ball. Tyler Ball is then wrapped up by Offerman at the 44-yard line, bringing up a third down and 5 for Iowa Wesleyan.
Big third down for the Blue Jay defense here. Get off the field again. Get the ball back in your offense's hands and let them go to work.
Three wide receivers, Cole to the left of Chevalier on the near hash. Takes a snap, looks near hash, finds Cole. He runs to the 50, 45, down the sideline, and he steps out of bounds at the 44-yard line of the Blue Jays. A good third down pickup, and the Tigers convert. Left in the first half of play. As the clock begins ticking once again, Tyler Ball on the near side, three wide receivers, Cole to the right is Chevalier. for rushing for the Blue Jays. Fake handoff to Cole. Schindler pump fakes, rolls to his left, running away from pressure, and then is dropped. Dropped at the line of scrimmage.
Helmet popped off there.
His helmet popped off. Good pursuit by Rothman Harris III, 5'11 sophomore out of Farmington, Missouri. He's been active today. And he contains Chevalier. Good coverage on the backside from the Westminster secondary. 13-0, Iowa Wesleyan leads. At the 44-yard line on the near side hash, as Gavin Esquivel enters the game, the backup quarterback, but he started before for Iowa Wesleyan. He hands it off, and Stafford Lewis looking for room, doesn't have any. It's Offerman. Once again, the backfield making the stop.
He's made a lot of noise for this defense today.
Chevalier returns after his helmet popped off. And Esquivel leaves. 13:03 left in the first half of play. Iowa Wesleyan with the ball in the middle of the field at the 44-yard line. Four wide receivers in the formation for the Tigers. Ferguson on the near side, defended tightly by Anthony. Press coverage. Chevalier takes a snap, and then it is quickly dropped. Didn't have a whole lot of time, and the Westminster defense picks up a sack. Andrew Friend, not so much a friend to Chevalier today. And he drops him across the 50-yard line.
That's huge. Push them back a little bit more, make their punter kick from a few more yards back. Maybe you can get a little bit more space to run. Maybe we'll see a big return here from the return team for the Blue Jays.
Paskowitz looking at the referee as the whistle, he's confused about the whistle maybe not being blown to start the play. And we'll reset at the 48-yard line. And Westminster's defense gets a stop. Two back to receive, Peyton James and Pitsenberger back for Westminster. Paskowitz to punt for Iowa Wesleyan, punts it from the 35. End over end spiral that takes a dribble and a bounce, a Westminster bounce, out of bounds on the near side at the 13-yard line, and Iowa Wesleyan will take over. Westminster will take over. Jordan Kern was able to pick up the first down for Westminster today, but then Westerfield threw an interception to Joseph Pace. So Westminster deep in their own territory, trying to pick up some more momentum. Iowa Wesleyan leads 13-0 with 11:49 left to play in the first half.
Long field to go here. Got to get the ball moving now. Can't fall back on that third down.
It's been a lot of third downs for Westminster today, trying to get the run game going. As Taylor Dobbins behind Westerfield, Wyatt Robinson in the game as well. Four wide receivers. Toss to Dobbins, the far side, and he has stopped the backfield. Major Nykum, he's been a busy linebacker. One of the better ones for Iowa Wesleyan. A TFL for him. First, make that second down and 15 from the 9-yard line for Westminster as they are going backwards on this drive. Dobbins behind Westerfield. Four wide receivers in the formation. Westerfield takes the snap, hands it off. Takes it himself on the read option. Makes a man miss and is driven down. Takes a nice pop at the 14-yard line on the near side.
Now you're back to where you started.
He's able to get past the original line of scrimmage. Third down and 9 to go for the Westminster offense. 10:35 left to play in the first half. Iowa Wesleyan leading 13-0.
This expect Westminster to try and drive the ball deep here.
Some substitutions in for them. They get Kelton Virtue, the freshman. The Camdenton Laker checks in. Jabin Shockley with him on the near side. As Westminster has to burn a timeout as the play clock was running down. And we'll take a break with them with this timeout. Iowa Wesleyan leads 13-0.
The way we consume digital media in our world is constantly changing. The way we learn about it needs to change at that same pace. At Westminster College, we're putting you at the forefront of this interdisciplinary research by letting you experience firsthand some of these changes so you'll be better prepared to create it yourself when you leave our campus. In our labs, you'll experience cutting-edge technologies that will prepare you for a career in whichever sector of digital media that you're comfortable. You won't just hear about digital media, you'll experience it yourself.
Museums allow us to celebrate humanity's soaring achievements while also providing lessons on how to avoid the mistakes of our past. They can also amplify the voices of underrepresented groups while bringing economic uplift to communities. We invite you to explore this world while finding a rewarding career by becoming a museum.
The field, as we do as well at Blue Jay Stadium, third down and 9 to go at the Blue Jay 15-yard line. Westerfield in the pistol, Jordan Kern behind him. Third down and 9 to go. Iowa Wesleyan leading 13-0. Westerfield roll out to the left side, far side. Flips and throws. Clap Saddle is open at the 40. Down the field, 50, 45, 40 to 35. And is tackled from behind. But a big time catch and run for Dylan Clap Saddle.
Wow. I think the Iowa Wesleyan defense collapsed on Westerfield there. And that opened up the running lane forward.
What an impressive play. As that was not Westerfield. That was the backup quarterback, Peyton Byerly. 6'1 sophomore making that throw. And it's maybe some different offensive philosophy right now, trying to get anything going. As the penalty flag is out.
What do we got here?
Substitution infraction on Westminster, trying to get a change of personnel. So after the big play to Dylan Clapsaddle.
Moving backwards.
Back they go to the 35-yard line in Iowa Wesleyan territory. First down and 15 to go. 9:24 left in the first half of play. Billups is back in as a wing back. Jordan Kern behind Byerly now. Right-handed quarterback. Takes a snap, hands it off to Kern. Kern down the left side hash, and he got blasted, lost the football, and Iowa Wesleyan has recovered, and Jordan Kern is still on the turf. And so right as the Westminster offense has a little bit of momentum, they lose it quickly.
It's also Reese Davidson in at quarterback, freshman from Lake St. Louis, Missouri.
Injury timeout on the field. We'll take it with them. Iowa Wesleyan leads 13-0.
Museums allow us to celebrate humanity's soaring achievements while also providing lessons on how to avoid the mistakes of our past. They can also amplify the voices of underrepresented groups while bringing economic uplift to communities. We invite you to explore this world while finding a rewarding career by becoming a Museum Studies major at Westminster College.
That was Reese Davidson actually at quarterback for Westminster. Some miss-ups on the two deep and the roster, some differences. Davidson out of Lake St. Louis, Missouri, a freshman, 6'3". But the offense is no longer on the field for Westminster after the Jordan Kern fumble. He was able to get off the field. And now Chevalier, four wide receivers, takes a snap on the far side hash. Looking near side, caught by Tantalus. Makes a man miss to the 50, 45, 40. And he is pushed out of bounds into Blue Jays territory. They started on the 30-yard line. And they go all the way to the 36-yard line of the Blue Jays.
One play, flip the field. A lot more favorable situation for the Iowa Wesleyan offense.
50. Make that a 34-yard connection. So first down at the 36-yard line. Chevalier in the shotgun on near side hash of the 36. Takes a snap. Hand off to Stafford Lewis. Up the middle, driving. And is dragged down by Offerman at the 30-yard line. On the near side hash. At the 30, second down and six. Substitutions for the Westminster defense. Devin Miller back in at nose tackle with Garrett Berger. Chevalier in the shotgun. Cole behind him. Hand off to Cole. Cole driving up the middle, but right on cue, there's Devin Miller. There's a penalty flag flying in. And holding on the Westminster offense, Eli Shaw, the center. For the Iowa Wesleyan offense. So that's Jesus Carbajal, the junior, 280 pounds. He gets called for the holding penalty. And that'll drive Iowa Wesleyan back 5 yards. Make that 10 yards, 5 yards back from the original line of scrimmage.
Maybe a second down here.
A long second down, maybe second down and 16.
It's second and 14 on the scoreboard. Yeah.
Chevalier takes the snap, looks far side, looking for his wide receiver, and he's out of bounds. Just a bit too far for, I believe, Say McMillan, maybe Jaden Harris.
On third down here for the Tigers. They've shown they can pick it up through the air, so expect the same here.
Good coverage by Logan Blinken one-on-one with him on the outside. Seen a lot of man coverage out of the Westminster defense.
A lot of two-high man and a one-high man out of this Westminster College defense.
So now Sam McMillan checks in on the far side. Three wide receivers. Chevalier in the shotgun, Cole to the right. Third down and 14, bobbles the snap, rolls to his right, and pump fakes, now throws, and it's over the head of McMillan and incomplete, and the Westminster defense picks up another stop.
It's a beautiful backdrop for football game. Nice construction area. Next season, that'll be a nice bleacher and press box and stadium. So
it'll be nice for all the fans here in attendance wrapped around the field. They'll actually have one place to sit, some stadium seating.
Oh, yeah. In years past, it's been the same idea as this, where everybody's wrapped around, but we also had the other side of the field to wrap around with.
Don't have that this year. Westminster has flip sidelines as well. So Iowa Wesleyan takes over, or make that Westminster. As long as this is a punt from Iowa Wesleyan. They take a delay of game penalty, probably to give Paskowitz a little bit more room. Peyton James and Pitsenberger back for Westminster. Paskowitz stands at the Iowa Wesleyan 39, moving right to left. 7:41 left in the first half of play. They lead 13-0. Takes snap, puts his foot into it. Wobbler, returned by Pitsenbarger, and he is dragged for almost nothing. He's dragged down at the 15.
Maybe a 3-yard gain on that punt, but nothing much more.
Good coverage on the punt by Jadon Varnado. Out of Streamwood, Illinois. 7:31 left in the first half. Westminster offense returns after the long throw, the long connection from Davidson to Clapsaddle, and then the ensuing fumble by Jordan Kern.
Davidson's still in at quarterback.
So Welty has made a change in his 24th season. at the helm of the Westminster Blue Jays. New quarterback in, it's Davidson. Dobbins to his right, rolls to his right. Wide receiver's flushing out. Now looks, finds Clapsaddle behind the defense, but overthrows him by maybe 4 or 5 yards. Iowa Wesleyan having some trouble keeping up with Clapsaddle, though.
They are. He seems to be burning the defensive backs. Lots of crossing routes from him. He's been going across the field and getting open.
A little flag route, and Joseph Pace and the safety, Jakeem Brock, are having a little problem with communication on the near side, and Pace trying to talk to his sideline. On the near side hash, second down, 10 yards to go at the 15, 7:25, and ticking the first half, Westminster possession. Davidson handoff to Dobbins, right down the hash off the right tackle, and bounces out of the pile, but down for little to no gain. Maybe got a couple.
Those of you missing out on some Division I college football action, the Alabama Crimson Tide lead 17-16 over the Texas Longhorns going into the fourth quarter.
I'll be honest, that's kind of surprising that the Longhorns have stuck in it this long.
It's a good game, a close game. They haven't been able to catch any of it, but I'm sure we'll see highlights of it.
Third down and 8 to go at the Westminster 17-yard line, Lanier hash. Davidson the shotgun, Dobbins to his right, four wide receivers, two on each side, takes a snap, rolls to his right, gets away from a defender to the near side, and he just walks out of bounds, nothing open down the field. And Iowa Wesleyan with good coverage on third down, and here comes the Westminster punt unit once again.
Trying to make something happen. Third down, you have to try and make something happen. Nothing was open. Just go ahead, try and pick up as much as you can, get out of bounds, and live to fight another day. Don't put yourself in a position that's going to hurt you or your team.
Dawson Brandt to punt again. Tyler Ball at the 49-yard line.
Brandt punting from his own 2-yard line.
This punt left to right. Brandt takes a snap. End over end wobbler taken by Ball across midfield. Now runs back across midfield to the far side. Across the hash into the boundary, bounces off a couple defenders, running backwards, and he slips. Turf Monster eats him up at the 49-yard line. And Iowa Wesleyan comes back on the field. We haven't had a score here in a while from either squad. The Westminster defense has settled in.
Seems as though the Iowa Wesleyan defense has been settled in right from the get-go. They feel like they're right at home going against this Westminster offense.
Power package. Three running backs behind Chevalier in the formation. The farthest one back is Cam Cole at the 49-yard line. Chevalier under center takes the snap, handoff to Cole up the middle, and runs over Offerman to drag him for a couple more yards to the 43-yard line of the Blue Jays. 5:54 ticking in the first half of play. Iowa Wesleyan leads 13-0. The two passing touchdowns in the first quarter. Another power package, same deal. Chevalier under center takes it, hand off to Cole down the right hash, and he's near the first down marker. Right at the line of gain. And no indication yet, and it's going to be inches short. Third down and very short to go. Cam Cole still in the game, same formation, power package. A lot of Blue Jays in the box, no safeties deep. Chevalier fakes, looks near side, looking for his receiver, McMillan, and it's broken up. Good coverage by Anthony.
Great play by Rob Anthony.
Anthony, the senior, showing the experience. One-on-one coverage with McMillan. Chevalier has been looking McWilliams' way all day, and he just hasn't been able to make a connection with him. They're going to go for it on fourth down. Fourth down and one. Under center, handoff Cole up the middle, but gets the conversion, dragging the pile.
There is a flag on the play. to wait to see what that is.
Flag thrown by, I believe, the umpire, Jaron LeGrant. .459 after the first half is this holding. David Burkhart signals. Chop block on the Iowa Wesleyan offense. That penalty backs them up.
Out comes the punt team.
So Westminster saved by the Tigers penalty. Cam Cole can't get the conversion. And Paskowitz returns. Offense is sputtering on both sides right now in the second quarter. No points scored by either team. Iowa Wesleyan still leading 13-0. Paskowitz stands at the 31 on the far side hash. Snap. High snap. And it's blocked! The fumble, the punt block recovery is made, and the fumble out of bounds. What a play on the far side. A hectic one. Rothman Harris had the block of the punt out of bounds at the 39-yard line on the far side. Marcus Stevens out of Camdenton, the junior, has the fumble recovery. The big man, 240 pounds, rumbles out of bounds, fumbles it out of bounds, thankfully for Westminster.
Yeah. I got excited. I thought we were going to see a big man touchdown.
There was a lot of green turf in front of him. But they eventually catch up to him.
Once big men get running, it's hard to stop them.
Westminster has had a lot of good momentum plays. The offense just needs to convert.
It's also very easy for big men to get in their own way and trip over themselves.
Right. Davidson takes the snap, looks far side, and tight coverage by Joseph Pace on Shockley, and it's incomplete. Second down and 10 for the Westminster offense. Looking for any momentum right now. Special teams and the defense have come up strong for them in this quarter. Billups is in as a wing. On the far hash, Davidson hands off to Dobbins up the middle, and he's dragged down by the Iowa Wesleyan front. 2 yard gain on that. Make that one. And a third down and 9 for Westminster. Welty has gone to Davidson, and they've gone to the pass game a little bit more. They'll need that on third down. One wide receiver alone to the far side. The tight end, Virtue, onto the right of the offensive line. Two wing backs fake the handoff to Dobbins. Davidson over the middle, caught by Virtue. And he's dragging 3 Iowa Wesleyan defenders. That's what it takes to bring him down. Stood up at the 28-yard line, and Westminster picks up the first down.
Big tight ends are hard to take it down. Takes a lot of guys to take down a big tight end like that. Got a rally to the football. Keep him from moving anywhere. He didn't really move much once he got hit, but he kept fighting and made the defense work.
On the far side hash, 28-yard line. 3:39 and ticking. Iowa Wesleyan leads 13-0. Cole Yancey checks into the game. He's behind Davidson. One wide receiver, the far side, toss to Yancey. Yancey to the far side, and he is brought down by the Iowa Wesleyan front once again. They are swarming to the ball on any run play.
This will be a momentum shift here for the Blue Jays if they can get in the end zone. Going into halftime, they'll get the ball coming out of the locker room, get in the end zone, maybe some things to go over from your other drives, but at the end of the day, cut this lead down in half, going into half with the ball coming back.
Demetrius Boyd has been on a lot of those stops for Iowa Wesleyan, sophomore. Second down and 10 to go. No gain on that play. Cole Yancey behind Davidson. 4 wide receivers. Clap saddle to the near side. 2 on each. side of the formation. Davidson drops back, fires, looking, and there is nobody home. Some more miscommunication.
I believe he thought that Clapsaddle was running a go route or a post route. Clapsaddle seemed to be running an out.
It's been that kind of day for the Westminster offense.
A lot of miscommunication on routes between the receivers and the quarterbacks. And that shows with how they're moving the football.
And this is just the second game of the season. Still a lot to work on, but Westminster still looking for their first points of the year. Again, shut out against Knox College last week, 2:41 and ticking in the first half. Iowa Wesleyan leads 13-0. Davidson takes the snap off the far hash, rolls right, has some room, throws for Clapsaddle, and it's just a little bit long, and Clapsaddle can't drag his feet, can't make the catch either.
Fourth
right
down
around the four-yard line.
Fourth down again. Looks as though Welty is going to keep the offense on the field.
Another fourth down attempt for this Westminster team.
Two good plays they had. They had the first down if that throw is able to keep Clapsaddle in bounds, or if they probably have a touchdown if the communication was there, whether that's on the receiver or on the quarterback. They have another big play that they miscommunicated on this drive.
Yancey to the left of Davidson takes the snap, rolls to his left on fourth down, looking downfield, and it is going to be dropped. Almost fumbled the ball, bobbled it. And Major Nycomb and the Iowa Wesleyan defense make another stop, and it's a turnover on downs.
Davidson rolled out right and just had nowhere to go with the football and tried to make a play happen, tried to make a couple of guys miss in the backfield, but ultimately the blocking broke down, and the Iowa Wesleyan defense was able to get to him and get another fourth down stop.
So the Tigers offense takes over again. On the far side hash at their own 31. Three wide receivers and a trips to the near side. Stafford Lewis to the left of Chevalier. Chevalier takes a snap, looks to his left, and gets away from one Blue Jay defensive lineman, doesn't get away from the other. And a sack for the Blue Jays defense. It's Justin Scales, the senior from Trinity Catholic. Pass rush for Westminster heating up. Four down linemen for them. Now Chevalier, three wide receivers to the near side. Takes the snap, looks, has pressured again, and Westminster sacks him on back-to-back plays. He is driven back all the way to the 20-yard line. It's going to be third down and forever for this Tigers offense.
Scales again contributing to that sack. He's starting to get in his groove and find ways to beat this offensive line of the Iowa Wesleyan Tigers.
Third down and around 20, a minute 20 and ticking. Westminster has burned a lot of their timeouts already, so not a lot of time to save for the offense. Chevalier empty, alone, five wide receivers, takes the snap, looks far side, and it's picked up. Oh, it's dropped. My goodness. Blicken had that one right in his paws but couldn't hang on to it.
He had some room to run afterwards, too. I think he looked at it and he saw the open grass ahead of him and saw the end zone and got a little ahead of himself. But ultimately, the Blue Jay defense gets another stop. This Iowa Wesleyan offense.
Baskowitz at his own five to punt. Has to get away, evades one defender, now going to throw, and it's incomplete. What just happened? As there was free rushers after the punt block last time by Westminster, and now another special teams blunder from Iowa Wesleyan. I don't think that was a design fake.
I don't think that was a design sake. I think that was the Westminster rush got into the backspace, and everybody's screaming fire, 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 and trying to make something happen, and nothing came out of it. So Westminster College is going to take the ball at the 20 and hopefully have this ball inside the red zone and take it into a score to take into the locker room.
What a turn of events. It didn't look like Westminster was going to get much of an offensive chance to end the half. But now with 57 seconds to go, they're at the 20-yard line in the red zone. Four wide receivers for Davidson in the middle of the field. Dobbins to his right, rolls right off the snap, looking downfield towards the end zone, and his pass is overthrown for Clapsaddle right at the corner of the end zone.
Clapsaddle seems to be a favorite target for this Westminster passing offense. He's shown that he can get open. It's just getting the ball to him in the right spot.
He's made some big plays today. When they have the connection right, the Tigers' secondary hasn't had too much of an answer. 52 seconds, Iowa Wesleyan leads 13-0. Westminster at the 20-yard line, 20 yards to the end zone.
Nice heavy set here for
a much different look. Shockley, the one wide receiver alone to the near side. Handoff, Dobbins up the middle, and he is brought down after a gain of six. Clock running. No timeout taken. Third down and four. Hurry up to the line. Iowa Wesleyan has to burn a timeout, and that's a saving grace for Westminster. With 34 seconds left, they take the timeout. Iowa Wesleyan leading 13-0. Third down and four to go out of this timeout. We saw them shift the personnel a lot there, go from trying to get a spread look to the power package. What do you expect on this third down?
Well, it's about, looks to be about a third and five, third and four. Westminster's been moving the ball well through the air when they can get the guys open. I wouldn't, with this time left, I would expect a passing play. But I also, knowing how they ran last week with a lot of triple option, I would not be surprised to see another power package come out. And it looks like they're going to keep the power package on the field as number 41, Kendall Outlaw, and number 21, Wyatt Robinson, will stay in the game along with Dobbins.
34 seconds to score for Westminster. Third down and four. Davidson with a triple option look. Shockley alone again. Dobbins behind Davidson. Hands it off to Dobbins. Dobbins up the middle, has some room, and he's right at the first down marker at the 10-yard line. That should be a first down, and that should stop the clock.
First down, stop the clock.
That should stop the clock for the chains to move. Referees blow the play dead to stop time. 27.4 seconds to be put back on the clock.
Heavy set again for Westminster.
Go right back to the same look. Time will start with the referee Burkhart. Shockley alone to the near side. Davidson hands it off to Dobbins. Dobbins splits the tackle in the guard up the middle to the 6-yard line. And with 20 seconds left, timeout Westminster.
That's the last timeout that Westminster has. So 5 yards to go. Expect maybe two shots at the end zone.
You'd think, but I'm wondering if they're going to try to run the ball again.
They might. I'd just be careful, be wary about running the football, especially if you want to make a change on personnel, unless that's what they're doing right here, this timeout. No timeouts left. Can't stop the clock. You got to find a way to get into the end zone if you run the football.
How about the quarterback change, though? Going away from Westerfield, had his struggles early on in this game, and they go to the freshman, another freshman, yeah. This time Davidson.
I don't know what's going on with Welty. We did see Westerfield kind of limp off the field earlier in the game. I wonder if it's something with that or if it's just a straight change from Welty. Out comes the heavy package again for the Blue Jays.
Second down. They have it at the 5-yard line. It's goal to go. 20 seconds remaining. Iowa Wesleyan leads 13-0. Westminster trying to score their first points of the season. Both teams trying to pick up their first win. Dobbins behind Davidson. Davidson takes the snap, looks far side. It's complete, and the wide receiver tries to go over the end zone.
They call him down at the one.
They call him down at the one. Kelton Virtue They stop the clock. The clock needs to run. 12 seconds remaining. They rush to the line. Davidson, quarterback sneak. Did he get in? The far side ref running in. They got to make a decision because the clock is running. Unbelievable end to the first half. Right at the goal line, Westminster is stopped. I can't believe that they didn't get in. Kelton Virtue on the play before trying to have his arm across.
Iowa Wesleyan already heading to the locker room.
I don't think they should. This is a conversation with the referees. They have to make some sort of designation on what the end of the play is going to be, if they're going to mark him in the end zone or short. I doubt they're going to bring him back out on the field, as that is a blunder. And if I'm John Welty, I'm pretty upset because there should have been another chance for them to maybe spike the ball or something to get one more play before the end of the half. But both teams entering the locker room, and Iowa Wesleyan picks up a critical stop to end the first half, and they still lead by 13 points, 13 to nothing. No points scored in the second quarter, but we'll be back with the second half of play here in Fulton, Missouri. Iowa Wesleyan leads 13 to nothing.
Today's typical college student is no longer the recent high school graduate. Almost half of all college students in the United States are age 24 or older, and they have busy lifestyles. They have families, they work part-time jobs or full-time jobs, and they want to earn a college degree. As you could imagine, the traditional college experience just doesn't work for them. Westminster College has a rich history of excellence in cultivating leaders. And now we can take that experience beyond our campus. We're proud to announce the launch of Westminster Online. It's designed to be flexible and to meet your needs. This program runs in back-to-back 7-week sessions so you can finish your degree faster. It's 100% online, so you can attend class on your schedule. You can choose to major in either business administration, organizational leadership, or in psychology. Westminster Online is affordable, and if you need to pause your studies, because life happens, you can do that. You're able to sit out a session and then come back when you're ready. Check out our website at wcmo.edu to learn more.
The way we consume digital media in our world is constantly changing. The way we learn about it needs to change at that same pace. At Westminster College, we're putting you at the forefront of this interdisciplinary research by letting you experience firsthand some of these changes so you'll be better prepared to create it yourself when you leave our campus. In our labs, you'll experience cutting-edge technologies that will prepare you for a career in whichever sector of digital media that you're comfortable. You won't just hear about digital media, you'll experience it yourself.
Museum Studies at Westminster is a program where students create and curate exhibitions, design programs, ask challenging questions, and above all, blend history, heritage, and culture in a way that informs and inspires. We invite you to join us at Westminster and be a part of history in a way that not only preserves the past, but through the power of museums, helps to build a better future.
Museums allow us to celebrate humanity's soaring achievements while also providing lessons on how to avoid the mistakes of our past. They can also amplify the voices of underrepresented groups while bringing economic uplift to communities. We invite you to explore this world while finding a rewarding career by becoming a Museum Studies major at Westminster College.
Financial planning is one of those careers that fuels you with your own professional accomplishment as well as a deep mental satisfaction from helping your clients directly. For example, as a financial planning professional, you'll help your clients in developing such personal financial plans as estate planning and retirement planning. Our curriculum also aligns well with the CFP course learning outcomes. Here at Westminster, you can also pursue a dual degree in financial planning and finance to further your career.
Today's typical college student is no longer the recent high school graduate. Almost half of all college students in the United States are age 24 or older. And they have busy lifestyles. They have families, they work part-time jobs or full-time jobs, and they want to earn a college degree. As you could imagine, the traditional college experience just doesn't work for them. Westminster College has a rich history of excellence in cultivating leaders. And now we can take that experience beyond our campus. We're proud to announce the launch of Westminster Online. It's designed to be flexible and to meet your needs. This program runs in back-to-back 7-week sessions so you can finish your degree faster. It's 100% online so you can attend class on your schedule. You can choose to major in either business administration, organizational leadership, or in psychology. Westminster Online is affordable, and if you need to pause your studies, because life happens, you can do that. You're able to sit out a session and then come back when you're ready. Check out our website at wcmo.edu to learn more.
The way we consume digital media in our world is constantly changing. The way we learn about it needs to change at that same pace. At Westminster College, we're putting you at the forefront of this interdisciplinary research by letting you experience firsthand some of these changes so you'll be better prepared to create it yourself when you leave our campus. In our labs, you'll experience cutting-edge technologies that will prepare you for a career in whichever sector of digital media that you're comfortable. You won't just hear about digital media, you'll experience it yourself.
Museum Studies at Westminster is a program where students create and curate exhibitions, design programs, ask challenging questions, and above all, blend history, heritage, and culture in a way that informs and inspires. We invite you to join us at Westminster and be a part of history in a way that not only preserves the past, but through the power of museums, helps to build a better future.
Museums allow us to celebrate humanity's soaring achievements while also providing lessons on how to avoid the mistakes of our past. They can also amplify the voices of underrepresented groups while bringing economic uplift to communities. We invite you to explore this world while finding a rewarding career by becoming a Museum Studies major at Westminster College.
Financial planning is one of those careers that fuels you with your own professional accomplishment as well as a deep mental satisfaction from helping your clients directly. For example, as a financial planning professional, you'll help your clients in developing such personal financial plans as estate planning and retirement planning. Our curriculum also aligns well with the CFP Board's learning outcomes. Here at Westminster, you can also pursue a dual degree in financial planning and finance to further your career.
Today's typical college student is no longer the recent high school graduate. Almost half of all college students in the United States are age 24 or older, and they have busy lifestyles. They have families, they work part-time jobs or full-time jobs, and they want to earn a college degree. As you could imagine, the traditional college experience just doesn't work for them. Westminster College has a rich history of excellence in cultivating leaders. And now, we can take that experience beyond our campus. We're proud to announce the launch of Westminster Online. It's designed to be flexible and to meet your needs. This program runs in back-to-back 7-week sessions, so you can finish your degree faster. It's 100% online, so you can attend class on your schedule. You can choose to major in either business administration, organizational leadership, or in psychology. Westminster Online is affordable, and if you need to pause your studies, because life happens, you can do that. You're able to sit out a session and then come back when you're ready. Check out our website at wcmo.edu to learn more.
The way we consume digital media in our world is constantly changing. The way we learn about it needs to change at that same pace. At Westminster College, we're putting you at the forefront of this interdisciplinary research by letting you experience firsthand some of these changes so you'll be better prepared to create it yourself when you leave our campus. In our labs, you'll experience cutting-edge technologies that will prepare you for a career in whichever sector of digital media that you're comfortable. You won't just hear about digital media, you'll experience it yourself.
Museum Studies at Westminster is a program where students create and curate exhibitions, design programs, ask challenging questions, and above all, blend history, heritage, and culture in a way that informs and inspires. We invite you to join us at Westminster and be a part of history in a way that not only preserves the past, but through the power of museums, helps to build a better future.
Museums allow us to celebrate humanity's soaring achievements while also providing lessons on how to avoid the mistakes of our past. They can also amplify the voices of underrepresented groups while bringing economic uplift to communities. We invite you to explore this world while finding a rewarding career by becoming a Museum Studies major at Westminster College.
Financial planning is one of those careers that prepares you with your own professional accomplishment as well as a deep mental satisfaction from helping your clients directly. For example, as a financial planning professional, you'll help your clients in developing such personal financial plans as estate planning and retirement planning. Our curriculum also aligns well with the CFP Board's learning outcomes. Here at Westminster, you can also pursue a dual degree in financial planning and finance to further your career.
Today's typical college student is no longer the recent high school graduate. Almost half of all college students in the United States are age 24 or older, and they have busy lifestyles. They have families, they work part-time jobs or full-time jobs, and they want to earn a college degree. As you could imagine, the traditional college experience just doesn't work for them. Westminster College has a rich history of excellence in cultivating leaders. And now, we can take that experience beyond our campus. We're proud to announce the launch of Westminster Online. It's designed to be flexible and to meet your needs. This program runs in back-to-back 7-week sessions, so you can finish your degree faster. It's 100% online, so you can attend class on your schedule. You can choose to major in either business administration, organizational leadership, or in psychology. Westminster Online is affordable, and if you need to pause your studies, because life happens, you can do that. You're able to sit out a session and then come back when you're ready. Check out our website at wcmo.edu to learn more.
The way we consume digital media in our world is constantly changing. The way we learn about it needs to change at that same pace. At Westminster College, we're putting you at the forefront of this interdisciplinary research by letting you experience firsthand some of these changes so you'll be better prepared to create it yourself when you leave our campus. In our labs, you'll experience cutting-edge technologies that will prepare you for a career in whichever sector of digital media that you're comfortable. You won't just hear about digital media, you'll experience it yourself.
Museum Studies at Westminster is a program where students create and curate exhibitions, design programs, ask challenging questions, and above all, blend history, heritage, and culture in a way that informs and inspires. We invite you to join us at Westminster and be a part of history in a way that not only preserves the past, but through the power of museums, helps to build a better future.
Museums allow us to celebrate humanity's soaring achievements while also providing lessons on how to avoid the mistakes of our past. They can also amplify the voices of underrepresented groups while bringing economic uplift to communities. We invite you to explore this world while finding a rewarding career by becoming a Museum Studies major at Westminster College.
Financial planning is one of those careers that prepares you with your own professional accomplishment as well as a deep mental satisfaction from helping your clients directly. For example, as a financial planning professional, you'll help your clients in developing such personal financial plans as estate planning and retirement planning. Our curriculum also aligns well with the CFP Board's learning outcomes. Here at Westminster, you can also pursue a dual degree in financial planning and finance to further your career.
Today's typical college student is no longer the recent high school graduate. Almost half of all college students in the United States are age 24 or older, and they have busy lifestyles. They have families, they work part-time jobs or full-time jobs, and they want to earn a college degree. As you could imagine, the traditional college experience just doesn't work for them. Westminster College has a rich history of excellence in cultivating leaders, and now we can take that experience beyond our campus. We're proud to announce the launch of Westminster Online. It's designed to be flexible and to meet your needs. This program runs in back-to-back 7-week sessions so you can finish your degree faster. It's 100% online so you can attend class on your schedule. You can choose to major in either business administration, organizational leadership, or in psychology. Westminster Online is affordable, and if you need to pause your studies, because life happens, you can do that. You're able to sit out a session and then come back when you're ready. Check out our website at wcmo.edu to learn more.
The way we consume digital media in our world is constantly changing. The way we learn about it needs to change at that same pace. At Westminster College, we're putting you at the forefront of this interdisciplinary research by letting you experience firsthand some of these changes so you'll be better prepared to create it yourself when you leave our campus. In our labs, you'll experience cutting-edge technologies that will prepare you for a career in whichever sector of digital media that you're comfortable. You won't just hear about digital media, you'll experience it yourself.
Museum Studies at Westminster is a program where students create and curate exhibitions, design programs, ask challenging questions, and above all, blend history, heritage, and culture in a way that informs and inspires. We invite you to join us at Westminster and be a part of history in a way that not only preserves the past, but through the power of museums, helps to build a better future.
Museums allow us to celebrate humanity's soaring achievements while also providing lessons on how to avoid the mistakes of our past. They can also amplify the voices of underrepresented groups while bringing economic uplift to communities. We invite you to explore this world while finding a rewarding career by becoming a Museum Studies major at Westminster College.
Financial planning is one of those careers that prepares you with your own professional accomplishment as well as a deep mental satisfaction from helping your clients directly. For example, as a financial planning professional, you'll help your clients in developing such personal financial plans as estate planning and retirement planning. Our curriculum also aligns well with the CFP Board's learning outcomes. Here at Westminster, you can also pursue a dual degree in financial planning and finance to further your career.
Today's typical college student is no longer the recent high school graduate. Almost half of all college students in the United States are age 24 or older, and they have busy lifestyles. They have families, they work part-time jobs or full-time jobs, and they want to earn a college degree. As you could imagine, the traditional college experience just doesn't work for them. Westminster College has a rich history of excellence in cultivating leaders. And now, we can take that experience beyond our campus. We're proud to announce the launch of Westminster Online. It's designed to be flexible and to meet your needs. This program runs in back-to-back 7-week sessions, so you can finish your degree faster. It's 100% online, so you can attend class on your schedule. You can choose to major in either business administration, organizational leadership, or in psychology. Westminster Online is affordable, and if you need to pause your studies because life happens, you can do that. You're able to sit out a session and then come back when you're ready. Check out our website at wcmo.edu to learn more.
The way we consume digital media in our world is constantly changing. The way we learn about it needs to change at that same pace. At Westminster College, we're putting you at the forefront of this interdisciplinary research by letting you experience firsthand some of these changes so you'll be better prepared to create it yourself when you leave our campus. In our labs, you'll experience cutting-edge technologies that will prepare you for a career in whichever sector of digital media that you're comfortable. You won't just hear about digital media, you'll experience it yourself.
Museum Studies at Westminster is a program where students create and curate exhibitions, design programs, ask challenging questions, and above all, blend history, heritage, and culture in a way that informs and inspires. We invite you to join us at Westminster and be a part of history in a way that not only preserves the past, but through the power of museums, helps to build a better future.
Welcome back to Kent and Judith Miller Field at Blue Jays Stadium as we're about to kick off for the second half.
Thank you, Hunter. Aaron Mosier and Hunter Mulholland with you. The second half, Iowa Wesleyan leading 13-0. After two first quarter passing touchdowns, but both defenses settled in the second quarter. And no scores from either of them in that 15 minutes of play. We've got 30 more minutes of regulation time in Fulton, Missouri. Moving left to right, Iowa Wesleyan getting set to kick us off. Lucas Mosqueda runs up, puts his foot into it, and it's end over end to the 10-yard line, returned by Pitsenberger. Pitsenberger running across the field towards the near side to the 26, and he's pushed out of bounds at the 28-yard line by Joseph Pace. Oh, some fighting going on the near side. Dante Billups. Some pushing and shoving with an Iowa Wesleyan defender.
There's a flag down.
Now, this is definitely going to be unsportsmanlike conduct.
I wonder which team it's going to be. There's two flags on the field. It's probably on both teams. It's going to be offsetting penalties here.
That was Marcus Christian. For Iowa Wesleyan, with meeting up with Dante Billups. In any case, first down and 10 for Westminster after the offsetting penalties. On the near side, hash of the 29-yard line. We saw Davidson take over for Westerfield. He's back in. Three wide receivers, hand off to Dobbins. Dobbins up the middle, picks up about three to the 32-yard line down the near hash. Reese Davidson in the pistol, Wyatt Robinson the wing back. Three wide receivers, handoff. No, fake, read option. And Davidson keeps it himself down the middle of the field, in between the hashes, and he's right near the first down marker.
Westminster starting to move the football.
Third down and one as now they move the chains. First down for Westminster. Reese Davidson picks it up himself.
So far in this first drive, Westminster seems to be moving the football a lot better than the first half.
They couldn't pick up a first down for, I believe, the whole first quarter. Davidson with a motion on the wing, handoff for Dobbins, and Dobbins still driving the pile for maybe a pickup of two. Down to the 42-yard line. 13, 32, and ticking. Iowa Wesleyan leading 13-0. Both teams looking to pick up their first win of the season. Westminster still looking for their first points of the season as well. Cole Yancey, the freshman out of Davenport, Oklahoma, is behind Davidson. Three wide receivers. Handoff, no, Davidson keeps it, tosses to White Robinson on the triple option off of the sweep, and he picks up the first down. He's right at the line to gain at the 49.
Calling him short.
Surprising to me, they mark him short. He might have gone out of bounds right there at the 49 and a, at the 49. I mean, they are inches, centimeters away from a first down. Third down and one on the far hash. Davidson, a motion, takes a snap, handoff to Yancey. Yancey trying to drive, spins, and he's going to get stuffed. Stuffed by the Tigers' defensive front. And after being centimeters from converting, they just lost 2 yards.
Blue Jays seem to be sending out the punting unit.
Kendall Outlaw, the tight end, just couldn't do enough on the lead block to open up anything. And surprising for Westminster, as they were at the goal line to end the first half with time ticking down, two tries and they couldn't get in. Virtue trying to reach across, and then Peyton make that Davidson trying on the QB sneak, and they couldn't score. Dawson Brandt to punt. He's been busy today. He's going to keep it himself, and he's going to lose a lot of yardage and a turnover on downs for Westminster.
Another misfire on the punting team. Special teams today on both sides. There's been a couple misfires. One a blocked punt and two scrambles by the punter.
So the Iowa Wesleyan offense returns. Zach Chevalier, two touchdown passes in the first half. One to Tyler Ball and one to Jamarian Ferguson. Stafford Lewis behind Chevalier, one running back to his right as well. Motion. Fake the motion sweep to the near side. Stafford Lewis off the catch and run to the 40, to the 35, 30. Down the sideline and tiptoes to maybe the 27-yard line. 28 is where they mark him out. A lot of rack on that run by Lewis. He subs out for Cam Cole.
Got a Blue Jay player down on the Iowa Wesleyan sideline. You come to a stoppage in play.
I believe that's the safety, Dylan Farrell, and while they look at him, we'll take a timeout. Farrell able to walk off to the Westminster sideline. Seems to be okay. First down It's in to go at the 28-yard line in Westminster territory. Chevalier and the Iowa Wesleyan Tigers driving. Cole to the left of Chevalier. Hands it off to him. Down the middle, down the right hash, and he is brought down by Dawson Brandt, who was busy in the first game of the season as he had 10 tackles against Knox. 11:04 and ticking in the second half of play in the third quarter. Iowa Wesleyan leading 13-0. Chevalier takes a snap, fakes the handoff, throws over the middle, complete, and it's caught and brought down at the 10-yard line. That's Angel Lottie, 5'9 wide receiver out of Des Moines, Iowa, and another Blue Jay is down.
Taken down by number 15, Colton Sheehan.
I don't know who the Blue Jay is that's down, but we'll take another timeout while they look at him.
Museums allow us to celebrate humanity's soaring achievements while also providing lessons on how to avoid the mistakes of our past. They can also amplify the voices of underrepresented groups while bringing economic uplift to communities. We invite you to explore this world while finding a rewarding career by becoming a Museum Studies major at Westminster College.
Help Andrew Friend limp off to the sideline, favoring that left leg. And the Iowa Wesleyan offense returns to the field. Nine at the 9-yard line is where they sit. First down and nine to go. Power package. And Cam Cole takes the handoff up the middle, down the right hash, and he is brought down. After a short pickup, picks up maybe one. And now a platoon substitution as the Tigers go to a different look. 10:20 remaining in the third quarter of play. Tigers lead 13-0 over Westminster with the ball. Second down, eight to go. Three wide receivers in the formation. Chevalier with Cole next to him. Takes the snap, handoff, bouncing up the middle. Touchdown, Iowa Wesleyan, Cam Cole. Into the end zone, his first touchdown of the 2022 campaign. And Iowa Wesleyan extends their lead to 19.
Great blocking scheme by that offensive line. Opened up a lot of holes for Cam Cole to run right into the end zone. A lot of green ahead of him.
Mosqueda sets up, and his extra point attempt is good. Hey, 20-0, Iowa Wesleyan leads over Westminster. Westminster has had their offensive opportunities, haven't converted, while Iowa Wesleyan has found the end zone three times.
Big hole for the Blue Jay offense to get themselves out of here. They need a three-score game. They've got 25 minutes of game clock to kick back. Need a stop from their. They need to get in the end zone here and get in quick and get some stops from the defense.
I mean, they're still looking for their first points of the season. I mean, the offense eventually has to find something. They've turned the ball over several times. One interception, fumbled by Jordan Kern.
Plenty of turnover on downs and
lots of punts.
Iowa Wesleyan defense has played well for the most part. I mean, the Blue Jays have really shot themselves in the foot.
They've broken a lot of big plays, but other than that, can't rely on chunk plays to win you games. You gotta do the little things, pick up little gains, and consistently move the football down the field.
Peyton James back to receive this punt all alone. This kickoff.
Switch up with the returner here.
Yeah, no Pitts and Barger. with 10 minutes remaining in the third quarter. A run up from Mosqueda left to right. A good boot. James takes it at the 2-yard line, runs it down the near side hash. Runs crossing towards midfield. Slips through a couple tackles into a pile. Pushing the pile, Westminster with the momentum. Still going past the 30, then all the way to the 33-yard line, maybe the 32 and a half.
Looked like a rugby scrum out there.
Impressive stuff from the return team as Peyton James was stopped at maybe the 25 momentarily as he slipped through a Tiger tackle.
Moved almost 10 yards up the field from in just the pile.
That has been one aspect of special teams that has gone pretty well for Westminster today. As they return to the field, Ben Wallace checks in for the first time today behind Reese Davidson. Jabin Shockley alone on the near side, two receivers to the far side. Four down linemen for the Tigers. Davidson tosses it to Wallace to the far side, down the hash. And he's brought down for no gain. .932 and ticking. Iowa Wesleyan leads 20-0. Both teams trying to pick up their first win of the season. Westminster 0-1. Picked to finish fifth in the UMAC coaches poll. Iowa Wesleyan 0-2. Same formation, three wide receivers, handoff. This time it's Dobbins up the middle, and he grinds through a couple of Tigers defenders and runs into the umpire.
Can we give him a tackle for that?
As Dobbins down to the 30, make that the 41-yard line. Third down and three to go, hustle to the line. Blue Jays take it, Davidson, handoff Dobbins. That's way too slow of a setup of a play. Moses Eason has been an X factor for the Iowa Wesleyan defense.
He has been blowing up that offensive line of the Blue Jays and really getting into that backfield and getting TFLs and sacks and quarterback pressures and quarterback hits. He's been the kryptonite of this Westminster offense today.
And they force another punt from the Westminster offense.
No return man for Iowa Wesleyan as of right now.
Nobody's running out. Well, I mean, Dawson Brant's ready to punt from his 26-yard line. As this is a full send to block the punt. Brant gets it away. Line drive takes a Blue Jays bounce across the 30, and it stops at the 25. Iowa Wesleyan banking on blocking the kick more than worrying about a return. Not the worst strategy in this game.
With the way that the special teams have been played on both sides with the punt teams, I wouldn't have expected anything different. Lots of pressure to those punters and causing a lot of problems on the special teams side of the ball.
The Tigers drove down the field about 50 yards to the end zone, their last possession. They lead 20-0 with the ball moving left to right. Stafford Lewis to the left of Chevalier on the near side hash. Three wide receivers. Chevalier takes a snap at his helmet. Rolls to his left, looking downfield. Finds ball, and it's broken up by Blicken as he poked it out of his hands. Blicken.
Got a holding on the offense as well.
Good coverage by Blicken. Not that it matters now. He had almost an interception in the first half. It went right through his hands. He had a lot of green turf in front of him, but unfortunately for Westminster, he couldn't hold on. But that penalty backs up Iowa Wesleyan. 10 yards, holding on them. And they're back on the 15-yard line, right smack dab middle of the field. Damian Tantalus runs in to give Brian Battle a break at the wide receiver position. Four wide receivers of the formation, three in the trips to the near side. Chevalier the shotgun. 7:46 left in the third quarter. Chevalier takes the snap, looks near side, throws over the middle, looking, and it's picked off. It bounced off a defender and it's picked off by the Westminster safety. Tantalus makes the tackle on the near side of the 35-yard line. How about that for the Westminster defense? It's the safety, David Fenton. And Westminster takes over with good field position again.
Talk about Tiptrill all day long, and finally it falls in the favor of the Westminster Blue Jays.
Off the hands of Angel Lottie. Not sure who the Westminster defender who had the tight coverage on him initially, but it falls into the hands of Fenton. And Westminster takes over at the near side, 34 on the hash. 7:36 remaining in the third quarter. Iowa Wesleyan leading 20-0. Westminster trying to drive down and find their first points of the season. Reese Davidson subbed in earlier in the game to replace Westerfield. Dobbins behind him. Dante Billups in the wing set. Three wide receivers. Bobbles the snap. Davidson on the speed option. Gets it to Billups. Billups runs through a couple defenders down the near side to the 15-yard line. He's pushed out of bounds. Dante Billups with one of the better runs today for Westminster.
Takes him down to the 15-yard line, and you're looking again at another red zone opportunity for the Blue Jays. Hopefully they can find a way to punch it in and get on the board for the first time this season.
Credit to Jabin Shockley with the good block as a wide receiver on the near side, taking Joseph Pace out of the equation on that option. Davidson, same formation. Fakes the handoff, speed option to the right this time. He keeps it himself, and that's not going anywhere. Almost a WWE-type slam down from Gabe Baker of Iowa Wesleyan on the far side. And so second down, they lost a yard on that play. Second down and 11, trying to do that speed option again. Under 7 to play in the third quarter. Ball on the 16-yard line. Dobbins back in, Billups in as the wing back to the right. Three wide receivers, one to the near side, two to the far side. Davidson, the shotgun, takes the snap, rolls right. Looking downfield on the out route, it's out of bounds. The penalty flag is out. So that catch by Clapsetta likely will not stand. An Iowa Wesleyan defender was injured for a moment. Just lost his shoe and runs off the field, but I believe holding is called on Westminster. Seems like every time they get a nice big play, a big chunk play to get them into closer scoring range, they shoot themselves in the foot.
They're hurting themselves. Every single play that they've had with those chunk plays, it seems as though something has gone wrong, whether that's a miscue with the quarterback and the receivers or if it's a miscue on the line. And a penalty flag comes about, and here we are backing them up to the 26-yard line, and now they're out of the red zone when they initially started at the 15.
Second down and long. Second down and 21 at the 26-yard line, the far side hash. Three receivers make that two receivers to the far side, one to the near side. Davidson takes the snap, rolls to his left, looking downfield, turns, fires to the end zone, and it is broken up. Broken up by the safety, Jarius Evans, as he had two Blue Jays in the end zone. Might have been the tight end, Virtue, or Peyton James down there. It falls incomplete, third down and long. So make that Aiden Fonke was the intended receiver on that play. Third and 21, 6:19 in the third quarter. Iowa Wesleyan leads 20-0. Westminster with the football. Dobbins behind Chevalier in the shotgun. Rolls to his right, to the strong side. Throws down the field, looking to the end zone. And they call it incomplete as Fonke was pushed out of bounds. Made a great effort to get to that football. At the end of the day, it's incomplete.
Funky pleading his case to the referee there. To no avail as the ball will come back to the 26-yard line of the Blue Jays.
A couple of end zone shots by Reese Davidson. We've seen a more aggressive pass game since he's subbed in. And they need a lot of yards once again Fourth and 21. They have to go for it. 6:10 remaining in the third quarter.
Surprised we have not seen any sort of field goal attempt today.
Nothing. Three wide receivers. Dobbins to the right of Davidson. Davidson takes a snap, rolls to his left, pressured, tripped up, and sacked. And that's the end of the drive. Major Nykum with the sack. And Iowa Wesleyan takes over. I mean, there just has to be a lot of frustration building up for the Westminster offense at this point. So many opportunities to score, so close, so many times, and they just can't find the end zone. Iowa Wesleyan takes over at the 29-yard line, the near side hash. Chevalier with three wide receivers. Hands it off to Cam Cole. Cam Cole off the left tackle, up the middle of the field, into the secondary, and he dives forward. Past the 45-yard line. Mark him at the 47. Back to the shotgun. Chevalier, three wide receivers again. Blue Jays blitz with five. Hand off to Cole up the middle. Has more space. Green grass to the 45. 40, and it fumbled it at the 35.
Ball's out. They're calling him down, it looks like.
They call him down, and I do believe that's the right call. I think he lost that ball well after he had landed. At the 35 near hash.
That would have been devastating for Iowa Wesleyan if they did fumble that after two great runs by Cam Cole.
Lewis gives him a breather. Four wide receivers, trips to the far side. Lewis in motion. Chevalier looks his way. Down the far side, he bobbles the ball. Was that a forward pass or not? It's a fumble on the ground, and they finally say it's incomplete after Logan Blicken almost had a recovery, but I think that's a correct call. That was a forward pass.
If it was a backwards pass, I don't think it was going to matter as the ball rolled out of bounds. And it looks like they are calling it a backwards pass because they are backing up the Tigers. But the ball rolled out of bounds before Blicken was able to corral it.
At the 38-yard line in the middle of the field. 5:16 remaining in the third quarter. Iowa Wesleyan leading Westminster 20-0. They have the ball moving left to right. And Mitch Daniels takes a timeout. And we'll take a timeout with him. We'll be back.
Today's typical college student is no longer the recent high school graduate. Almost half of all college students in the United States are age 24 or older, and they have busy lifestyles. They have families, they work part-time jobs or full-time jobs, and they want to earn a college degree. As you could imagine, the traditional college experience just doesn't work for them. Westminster College has a rich history of excellence in cultivating leaders, and now we can take that experience beyond our campus. We're proud to announce the launch of Westminster Online. It's designed to be flexible and to meet your needs. This program runs in back-to-back 7-week sessions so you can finish your degree faster. It's 100% online so you can attend class on.
The offense returns to the field. Three wide receivers in the formation. They sit at the 37-yard line. In the middle of the field, Stafford Lewis to the right of Chevalier. I-15 remaining in the third quarter. Tigers lead 20-0. Takes the snap. Looks over the middle. Now near side. Pump fakes and is dropped. Ran out of time. He fumbled the ball. Ball still on the ground and finally recovered by the Blue Jays. They get a much-needed turnover. Rothman Harris the third.
That's Cam Offerman picking up the football again, making some noise for this Westminster College defense. Great play by Rothman Harris.
Yeah, he was the one that forced the fumble, had the sack. Chevalier ran out of time. Pump faked and held it for a little bit too long.
As Blue Jay defense is causing turnovers, and their offense is just not helping them out right now.
Westminster's defense, yeah, is playing about as much as you can ask for as much as they've been on the field. 20 points as many drives as the Tigers have had is very admirable.
Especially in the field position that they've had on a couple of them.
Three wide receivers. Davidson takes the snap, throws it to Dobbins near side, far side, and he dropped the ball. And it hit the ground incomplete. It has been that type of day for the Westminster offense, just putting themselves in their own way. Three wide receivers in the formation. Davidson takes the snap, looks near side, firing down the sideline, looking for Clapsell, it's picked off. Joseph Pace has it for Iowa Wesleyan at the 30-yard line. They give him forward progress at the 35.
Not ideal. And there's flags out on the field again. Some John with the between the Tigers and the Blue Jays.
Joseph Pace has had a good day defensively for the Tigers.
Two interceptions on the day.
And the story of the day for Westminster's offense. See what these penalties are about. One penalty against Westminster. Yeah. Might have been unsportsmanlike conduct after the play was over.
Frustrating day for this offense. I think it's starting to get to them. And you know, when things don't start going your way, you get a little bit angry, a little bit frustrated, a little bit chippy, and you know, you start shooting yourself in the foot more often than not with those penalties.
Davidson was looking for Clap Saddle down the sideline, and it was just an errant throw. Too short and not close enough to the sideline. Tigers return after fumbling on the last possession off of a sack by Rothman Harris. Chevalier returns with four wide receivers, trips to the near side. Man in motion towards the near side. Fake handoff, they throw it to him. And running, it's Tyler Ball. He's wrapped up after a gain of one by Anthony, Robert Anthony, the defensive back for Westminster, and he keeps that play to a minimum. Under five to play in the third quarter, 4:36 remaining. Tigers lead 20-0 over Westminster.
Second and nine here.
Second and nine for Chevalier in the shotgun, running back to his left. Three wide receivers, takes the snap, fakes the handoff, throw over the middle. It's complete to Angel Lott. He breaks a tackle, stiff arms one, and then is dropped. Dropped by Robert Anthony, the biggest hit of the day. But Angel Lottie does have a first down for Iowa Wesleyan.
Massive hit by Robert Anthony right there. He's laid the shoulder, no targeting, no dirty hit. Laid the shoulder right into the pads and right into the chest of the ball carrier. And clean hit.
Man,
a big hit.
Laying the lumber. Quickly back to the line, Iowa Wesleyan, three wide receivers. Fakes the handoff to Lewis. Chevalier looks near side looking for McMillan, and he dropped it. Robert Anthony pushed him out of bounds anyway, so
even if he
I don't think
caught
that
it.
Play would have counted, no matter if he made the catch or not. You know McMillan saw footsteps from the safety, David Fenton, after the big hit delivered by Anthony. Three wide receivers for Tigers once again. Cam Cole back in as the running back to the left of Chevalier. Chevalier takes the snap, hands it off to Cole. Cole off the right hash. Penalty flag is out off the run as Cam Cole had about 5 yards on that gain. Play is blown dead.
3:35 left in the third quarter.
Chop block on the Iowa Wesleyan offensive line. Ryan Norwood, the center, was one of the guilty parties.
Seen more chop blocks than holding penalties against this Iowa Wesleyan offense. You start to think maybe they're just trying to get low and stop this D-line and stop the pressure that keeps coming towards Chevalier. And sometimes you're gonna get caught up in the mess and you're going to end up moving backwards.
Now give credit to Justin Scales, Devin Miller, Rothman Harris.
I don't think the Chan Gang knows what's going on.
They've had trouble all day. We're set.
We're supposed to stay the original spot.
And now we have the time blown dead as now they reset. All growing pains to start this season as everybody on the field. It's the first home game here at Blue Jay Stadium in 2022. Westminster finished 2021 3-5, 2-4 in UMAC play. Trying to find a winning season once again. It's been a minute. Trying to find a winning season as well for Iowa Wesleyan. Both these programs are trying to get off the ground.
Iowa Wesleyan recently left Division III, moved to NAIA, left the UMAC, left the SLIAC, and all the other sports.
Chevalier takes the snap, fix handoff, throws over the middle, finds his man down the field. One man to beat, and Fenton does make the tackle. We haven't seen Terrell Holt today, but he makes that grab and runs down to the 14-yard line to the near side, down the near side hash, and Chevalier trying to increase this Iowa Wesleyan lead. They lead 20-0 over Westminster into the red zone. Cam Cole behind Chevalier, three wide receivers, handoff, Cole off the left tackle, down the left hash, and then stopped by Offerman. And he's tackled at the 12-yard line, make that the 8-yard line. Still can't pick up the first down at the 4-yard line. So second down and maybe 3 to go. Cam Cole to the right of Chevalier. Takes the snap, hands it off to Cole, and he's met in the backfield by a pair of Blue Jays. Garrett Berger and Justin Scales combined for the stop. So that brings up a third down for Iowa Wesleyan.
Here we go again. Another third down in the red zone for Iowa Wesleyan. Had success in the red zone.
Scored on a Cam Cole run last time they were down here. Stafford Lewis is in as the running back right now. He's to the right of Chevalier. Three wide receivers to the near side, one alone to the far side. Faked as Lewis, throw. And it's complete to the tight end, and he's driving, and he is down inside the 5 to the 3.
Picking up that first down, again, be a first and goal.
J.C. Gill, the freshman, made that grab. Inside the 5-yard line, first down, goal to go for the Tigers. Stafford Lewis behind Chevalier, under a minute to play in the third quarter. Two wide receivers to the far side, one on the near side. Chevalier hands it off. Lewis bounces and hurdles, trying to get into the end zone, but he has stopped just a bit short at the 1-yard line. The Blue Jays front eventually meets him. And a platoon substitution again from the Tigers. Cam Cole back in as running back. Elvis Irribulum, he's in for the Tigers offense. Second down and one. Second down and goal to go. 1 yard to the end zone. Power package for Iowa Wesleyan. Three sit behind Chevalier, under center. One wide receiver, McMillan, alone to the far side. The Blue Jays gather at the line of scrimmage. Chevalier takes the snap, handoff, Cole. Did he get in? No, they stop him once again as time elapses in the third quarter.
That goal line is a tough defender today, apparently.
Yeah, we've seen it stop Westminster a few times as starting the fourth quarter, Iowa Wesleyan will have the ball on a third down and goal to go from the one. We'll meet you there. The Tigers leading 20-0 over the Blue Jays.
The way we consume digital media in our world is constantly changing. The way we learn about it needs to change at that same pace. At Westminster College, we're putting you at the forefront of this interdisciplinary research by letting you experience firsthand some of these changes so you'll be better prepared to create it yourself when you leave our campus. In our labs, you'll experience cutting-edge technologies that will prepare you for a career in whichever sector of digital media that you're comfortable. You won't just hear about digital media, you'll experience it yourself.
Museum Studies at Westminster is a program where students create and curate exhibitions, design programs, ask challenging questions, and above all, blend history, heritage, and culture in a way that informs and inspires. We invite you to join us at Westminster and be a part of history in a way that not only preserves the past, but through the power of museums, helps to build a better future.
Seven degrees in Fulton, Missouri, as we start the fourth quarter with Iowa Wesleyan moving right to left. With 1 yard to go to the end zone, they lead Westminster 20-0. Power package again with Cam Cole lined up behind Chevalier. Two fullbacks in right behind him.
Timeout coming out of the break for the Blue Jays.
I don't know what they expected. I mean, they've run that power package at the goal line two times already.
Yeah, they've ran that. They've shown that they want to use that power package in short to gain situations, and they. I don't know why the Blue Jay defense was not prepared for that.
And after today, Westminster will go on the road to take on Sewanee, and then at Rhodes in Memphis, Tennessee, before they come back to face Minnesota Morris on October 1st.
Lots of traveling for this Blue Jays team. They're one of the southernmost teams in this conference, and they have to make trips quite a bit.
Say McMillan alone to the near side as here comes the power package again at the goal line. Chevalier under center. Takes the snap, runs it in on the QB sneak, and Iowa Wesleyan has gone up 26-0. The Blue Jays couldn't convert on their opportunities offensively today, and the defense can only do so much for them. As Lucas Mosqueda three for four on his point after attempts. As that one is good. And Iowa Wesleyan has increased their lead 27-0.
Blue Jays once again getting the ball back and in a situation that they don't want to be in. Last week we saw it with them and Knox getting down big and digging themselves into a hole offensively, and done it here again today and shooting themselves in the foot when big plays arise. It's not a key to success. There's been a lot of good, and there's been a lot of bad for this Blue Jay offense.
How can they kind of salvage this last 14:57?
I think that going down, getting a touchdown might help, you know, team morale, get in the end zone, maybe start to see, hey, we're starting to move the ball, and going into next week, work on some things at practice, and into next week, you see a little bit more offense come out of this Blue Jays team. There's been some good and some bad, like I said, but when the bad outweighs the good, it usually tends to.
Do you think we'll see Davidson start next week?
based off of his play today, I would not be surprised to see it. Now, that also could be it also could be a injury problem with Westerfield. Not 100% certain on that status there. I don't know if it's a straight swap or if it's a injury replacement.
Return from Westminster on the kickoff, close to the 40-yard line. Brought down at the far side at the 39-yard line is where they mark him. It was Colton Sheehan.
Got some cowbells in the stands today. I just showed up.
As the Westminster offense returns to the field, just trying to get anything positive going.
Had a beautiful day out here in mid-Missouri. And
I got to get something for the fans today.
Yeah.
Clap saddle and James to the near side. Dobbins behind Davidson. James in motion across the formation. Pitch to Dobbins to the far side. Makes one man miss on the juke. Rushes forward. Stays in bounds all the way to the 45. Conversation with the far side judges, and they mark him out at the 44. Positive run on first down. If you're Westminster, let's keep it manageable. Just try to build positive plays on top of positive plays.
Stay in between the sticks. Stay in between the sticks, you're usually set for success.
On the far hash, motion again from James, right to left. Handoff to Dobbins at the middle. Oh, Davidson keeps it, and he is dropped after the read option for no gain. They give him one generously. Major Nykum in on the stop. Another great day for him defensively. Standout on the Tigers' front seven. Same formation, two wide receivers near side. Dobbins behind Davidson, 13:34 left in the ball game. Iowa Wesleyan leading 27-0. Snap taken and rolling away from pressure, but not unable to escape is Davidson. And he's dropped in the backfield on a third down Demetrius Boyd.
See that inexperience from both quarterbacks for Westminster today, both of them freshmen. See that inexperience, especially in third down situations. They sit in the pocket too long. They don't push up and keep their eyes downfield. And they let the pressure get to them. They don't flush the pocket when they need to. And you see a lot of sacks today from the Iowa Wesleyan defense.
He had an opportunity to maybe step up in the pocket, but went right towards the right tackle that Demetrius Boyd had pushed back into him, and it was an easy sack for Boyd. The punt is recovered at the 44-yard line of Iowa Wesleyan, where they will take over. 12:39 left in regulation. Iowa Wesleyan leading 27-0. They return to the field on the far side hash at the 44-yard line.
Chevalier returns once again.
And no backups in quite yet for either side. Stafford Lewis to the left. No Jordan Beben today. He had the bulk of the carries last week against Missouri Baptist. He's a freshman as delay of game taken by Iowa Wesleyan.
Some confusion with the wide receivers on who was supposed to be on the ball and who was supposed to be off the ball as they were rushing to get that down.
Beben had 23 rushes for 135 yards last week. No sign of him today. First down and 15, now from the 39 on the far hash. Chevalier fakes, looks near side, now rolls far side to the 40, throws it, and it's overthrown. Too hot to handle for Jaden Harris on the far side, and more laundry out on the field. plenty of things to work on and practice next week for both teams. Even though Iowa Wesleyan is up, they've had their fair share of penalties, their fair share of turnovers. They had a punt blocked. And it's not been the prettiest of games today.
It is not.
Another penalty against Iowa Wesleyan will back him up even further. At the 35-yard line on the far hash is where they sit. First down and 20 yards to go. The line to gain is the 46-yard line on the other side of the 50. Three wide receivers in a trip to the near side. One to the far side. Running back to the right of Chevalier. Chevalier takes the snap, looks near side. And his receiver wasn't looking. Picked off. Robert Anthony down the 40 to the 30. Has blockers in front. 20, 15, 10. Steps out of bounds and he's pushed out at the 5. But he stepped his foot out at the 11-yard line. Another interception from the Westminster defense. The Iowa Wesleyan receiver wasn't even looking for the ball, and Chevalier throws another interception today.
It's a great play by the Westminster College defense as Robert Anthony takes that back for a big return. It sets the offense up for a very, very manageable 11 yards to get into the end zone. This is the best field position that Westminster has had all day long.
It has been miscommunication between quarterbacks and receivers for both squads today. That was Jaden Harris. I believe that might have been Terrell Holt as well. In any case, interception brings Westminster to the 11-yard line. First down, 10 to go. Dobbins behind Davidson. Davidson hands it off to Dobbins. Dobbins off left tackle and brought down after maybe a one-yard pickup. With 12:05 left to play, Iowa Wesleyan leading 27-0 over Westminster. Westminster moving left to right. Plenty and plenty of opportunities for them to score their first touchdown of the season, their first points of the season. They were shut out against Knox in week one, and they have yet to score today. Dobbins behind Davidson. He fakes the handoff to him. Davidson throw to the end zone. Touchdown, Westminster! Virtue has the reception and the touchdown, and Westminster is on the board in 2022.
It's a great, great route, great read by the quarterback to get that out quick and get that into the end zone as the Westminster College Blue Jays finally get on the board in 2022 and finally get on the board in this game in the fourth quarter. And it looks like we're going to see a point after attempt here.
Right to the back of the end zone. Kelton Virtue was wide open off the play fake. Play action drew the linebackers in, and he ran right behind him. And Davidson able to find him. With 11:39, Dawson Brandt to kick the extra point. The hold by Pittson Barger. Hold is good. The kick is blocked, though. Penalty flag is out.
I think somebody touched the center.
Is this encroachment on Iowa Wesleyan? You know, if Westminster gets a stop here, they could have some positive momentum to at least make this game closer.
Yeah, they get another stop and another turnover. As we've seen, the Westminster defense has been all over in terms of turnovers today.
So Westminster gets a second chance at the point after the penalty on Iowa Wesleyan. They set up once again.
This is the only time that the defense is going to be happy to get on the field again that quick.
Offsides on Iowa Wesleyan, a defender jumped. Tigers want a false start. And as the penalties just keep building today, we can't even kick an extra point.
Yeah.
That penalty is on Iowa Wesleyan. Offsides, half the distance to the goal, so we don't move but a few inches.
keep moving closer and closer to the goal line. At what point does John Welty send out his offense for a QB sneak?
Right. I mean, that's an opportunity right here. In any case, Dawson Brandt to kick the extra point. It's blocked again. My goodness. Just a comedy of errors as the recovery man for Iowa Wesleyan fumbled it. Thankfully, it bounced to another Tiger. And that was a mess of a sequence.
We almost saw weird rules. Recently on social media, the weird rule of the one-point safety has arose again. And we almost saw that here as the ball bounced back and almost went back into the end zone, in which if the Westminster PAT team was able to knock down and tackle the Iowa Wesleyan team in the end zone, that would be a point for Westminster on a one-point safety, the only way besides an extra point that you can actually score one singular point in a football game.
Still plenty to work on for that extra point team, as they had two extra point attempts blocked. And the man with the recovery was Derek Williams, and he was the one that fumbled it eventually. So Westminster getting ready to kick it off. After scoring their first points of 2022 off of the touchdown pass from Reese Davidson to Kelton Virtue, the freshman tight end. Stafford Lewis and Damian Tantalus back to receive for Iowa Wesleyan. We haven't seen that pair of returners today. Dawson Brandt to send us off. 11:39 to play in regulation. Iowa Wesleyan leads 27-6 over Westminster. Wobbler of a kick caught at the 22-yard line. Ran down the boundary and eventually stopped by the Westminster coverage team at maybe the 33-yard line. Might have been Jamarian Ferguson on the return for the Tigers, and they set up and they actually mark him at the 35-yard line. The interception gave Westminster the beautiful field position. Last time around, Chevalier with the miscommunication with his wide receiver, picked off by Robert Anthony and run down to the 10-yard line. Chevalier returns with two wide receivers to the near side, one alone to the far side. Cam Cole to the left of Chevalier. Chevalier fakes, throws to the near side, far side. Caught by McWilliams, and he spins out of a tackle and then is pushed out of bounds. Say McWilliams, his most impressive play of the day. He's pushed out of bounds after picking up the first down to the 49 of Westminster. 11:14 and ticking in regulation. Cam Cole still behind Chevalier. Same formation. Four down linemen for Westminster. Handoff, Cam Cole up the middle, breaks to the left, down the left hash, and brought down from behind by Garrett Berger, and he's not up, not down. Cam Cole stays on his feet and then is brought down out of bounds at the 10-yard line.
I think everybody thought that he had went down, and everybody kind of stopped playing football, but there was no whistle, and Cam Cole took advantage of that and picked up an extra yardage and got them to the 10-yard line. It seems like it's going to be a first and goal opportunity.
This game has gotten weirder and weirder as time has gone on. Chevalier in the shotgun, Stafford Lewis to his right. I'd love to see another look at that if Cam Cole really was down or not. He landed on top of Berger.
Sadly, we do not have replay review here.
I'm sure Westminster would love to have that to challenge that play.
Probably like it to challenge that goal line stop at the end of the first half.
Absolutely.
So it looks like it's going to be actually on the 11-yard line, and we'll have a first and 10.
on the near side hash. Chevalier with Lewis to his right. Three wide receivers. Fake handoff to Lewis to the far side. One-on-one. Batted up in the air. McWilliams couldn't make the grab. Blicking with the coverage. But a penalty is thrown in. I believe that will be on Logan Blicken.
They're calling pass interference on Blicken. It looked as though McWilliams had his arms completely around Blicken, and it actually looked more like a push off than a defensive pass interference.
Well, the penalty will move Iowa Wesleyan up. All the way to the 2 yard line. First down and goal to go. Power package again with two fullbacks behind Chevalier and then a lone running back as they move the ball to the near hash. Same McWilliams, this time matched up with Robert Anthony on the near side. First down and two to go. To the goal line. Toss, Stafford Lewis, one man to beat. Gets past Fenton and into the end zone. Penalty flag is out.
It looks as though he might have dropped it before he crossed.
Not sure what that penalty could be other than maybe taunting or maybe something on Fenton. Maybe horse collar, face mask on Fenton. I'm not sure what that flag is for. Penalty is on Iowa Wesleyan, and that takes away the touchdown. That had to be either holding, taunting, something of that sort. Didn't get a great look at it. And with 10:34 remaining in the ball game, Iowa Wesleyan moves backwards. Still goal to go, but they are at the 11-yard line. Make that the 13. Chevalier in the shotgun, Stafford Lewis to his right. Three wide receivers. Chevalier hands it off to Lewis up the middle, and then he is collapsed upon by the front seven and Justin Scales for Westminster. And ticking. Second down and 12 to go to the goal line. Chevalier in the shotgun again, same thing, three wide receivers. Lewis to the right of Chevalier. Chevalier fakes the handoff, trying to get away, and it's blown up. The ball is collected by Westminster. A penalty flag is down, but Westminster has the football.
It looks like it's going to be on Iowa Wesleyan as Justin Scales does not have his helmet. And we've got another Westminster player down. Lots of injuries here today for Westminster.
I think he was the one that had the football, and he landed awkwardly. That was Devin Miller. There was a wide-open Iowa Wesleyan receiver in the end zone, and Chevalier was looking for him, but he couldn't find enough room in the pocket as it collapsed. And we'll await the ruling as Devin Miller is able to get up.
Walk under his own power off of the field.
Westminster's defense is still on the field. John Welty is all the way out to the near side hash, talking with the official, awaiting this ruling.
Number 73, Ethan Talores, subbed in today on the defensive side of the ball. He's normally the offensive tackle. Senior from St. Clair, Missouri.
We saw Andrew Friend leave the game in the first half and haven't seen him return.
Talore stands at 6'3", 275, so not a small body that they are replacing there on the defensive line.
That penalty was on Westminster as they've moved the football up. Maybe hands to the face on the defense. Just a scrum of O-lineman and D-lineman.
Face mask on the defense. Been signaled here in the press box.
Second down and 5 to go. Goal to go for Iowa Wesleyan with 9:54 left in regulation, leading 27-6 over the Blue Jays. Chevalier in the shotgun, handoff. Cam Cole up the middle, and he runs into his own offensive lineman, but does get into the end zone.
Another flag out.
Another flag on the field, as you mentioned. But the Tigers' offense is leaving the field, and that might have been Cam Cole's second touchdown run of the day.
Lots of penalty yardage today for both sides.
Like we said, it has not been the most beautiful game of football. And the penalty is on Iowa Wesleyan, but it will be enforced on the kickoff, if I am reading that correctly. And Iowa Wesleyan has increased their lead to 33-6. Mosqueda sets up for another point after attempt. Hold is good. Kick is through the uprights. And Iowa Wesleyan takes a 34-6 commanding lead over Westminster. And 9:42 remaining. And this one. Iowa Wesleyan will follow this game.
It's a flag sitting on the field again.
More conversations between referees as they will be backed up on the kickoff. I mean, Westminster has had very good field position for a lot of drives today, and
they have.
Assuredly will get another great chance to have it on their to cross midfield and have it on the Tigers' half. Iowa Wesleyan next week will host Finlandia and then travel on the road at Dakota State on the 24th. They get to go all the way to Madison, South Dakota for that one. And then come back home for a two-game set to face Mayville State and then Dickinson State.
No movement. Either side, still flag sitting on the far sideline.
As they walk it forward.
Looks like there was a penalty on Westminster. And we will be back where we started for the kickoff.
Wouldn't you love to have them, the referees, mic'd up? So, one, they could tell us the official ruling, but we could also hear their conversation.
Yeah, I'd love to know what's going on and know what the call is rather than try and interpret what they're signaling with their hands.
Peyton James back to return. We haven't seen Pitsenbarger back there since he was subbed out As Mosqueda sets up at the 35 to send us away. 9:42 left to play in regulation. Tigers leading 34-6 over the Blue Jays. Here at Blue Jays Stadium in Fulton, Missouri. End over end kick. Peyton James takes it at the 12-yard line. He dropped it, bounces back to him, runs to the 20 on the near side, and then is brought down by a host of Tigers after a short pickup on the return. Reese Davidson and Taylor Dobbins return to the field. Jaben Shockley alone on their side. Two wide receivers to the far side. At 9:34 remaining, they start at the 20-yard line on the near side hash. Dante Billups, the wing back to the right of the offensive line. Hand off, no, keep. Davidson on the option, and he is met. And stuffed for no gain. Tigers flying to the ball. Time rolls. Under nine to play in regulation. Iowa Wesleyan looks to take their first victory of the season. Davidson takes the snap, gets away from one rusher, then can't evade being tripped up by another Tiger. Joseph Lozano, the freshman from Sacramento, California, trips up Davidson. They mark him back at the line of scrimmage. Third down and 10. The ball on the 20 on the far hash. During the really weird COVID season in the spring of 2021, this Iowa Wesleyan squad defeated Westminster 35-14 right here on this field. And it does not appear Westminster is going to be able to get revenge for that game. Cole Yancey, the freshman, is in to the left of Davidson. Two wide receivers, both sides. Near side, trying to set up the screen, claps saddle, can't get to it. That throw was too low and hits the turf. Brings up fourth down.
Well, there's a flag coming in. Lots of.
Penalty on Iowa Wesleyan.
Of dirty laundry out today.
That penalty keeps the Westminster offense on the field. Timeout taken by Iowa Wesleyan, and we'll take a timeout with them. They lead 30.
The way we consume digital media in our world is constantly changing. The way we learn about it needs to change at that same pace. At Westminster College, we're putting you at the forefront of this interdisciplinary research by letting you experience firsthand some of these changes so you'll be better prepared to create it yourself when you leave our campus. In our labs, you'll experience cutting-edge technologies that will prepare you for a career in whichever sector of digital media that you're comfortable. You won't just hear about digital media, you'll experience it yourself.
Ben Wallace is into the game for Westminster. Davidson and the pistol with Ball is behind him, three wide receivers. Fresh set of downs off the penalty by Iowa Wesleyan. As they do have some backups in on the defensive side of the ball. Reese Davidson in for, still in for Westminster, replacing Westerfield earlier in this game. Toss to Wallace to the far side, down the hash. And he is met. They give him, getting back to the line of scrimmage. Second down, 10 to go, 35 on the 35-yard line, far hash. 7:06 left to play in regulation. And another timeout on the field, this time for Westminster. We'll be back with more Westminster football.
Financial planning is one of those careers that prepares you with your own professional accomplishment as well as a deep mental satisfaction from helping your clients directly. For example, as a financial planning professional, you'll help your clients in developing such personal financial plans as estate planning and retirement planning. Our curriculum also aligns well with the CFP Board's learning outcomes. Here at Westminster, you can also pursue a dual degree in financial planning and finance to further your career.
Second down and 10 from the 35-yard line for Reese Davidson and the Westminster offense. Three wide receivers. Davidson on the far hash takes the snap. Looking near side, and Jabin Shockley defended tightly by a Westminster defender, Joe Sheeston, the junior.
Couldn't get any room to run on that. Try and get open and give Davidson a chance to get him the ball. It's great, great press coverage.
Clock has stopped at 6:58. Far hash again, third down and 10. Iowa Wesleyan leads 34-6. Westminster moving left to right. Rolling to the left, throw is picked off by Iowa Wesleyan. There is a penalty flag down, and Ben Wallace is shoving an Iowa Wesleyan defender. And it's gotten a little bit chippy. It's been a little chippy all day. It's been ugly all day. And as long as that penalty is on Westminster, Tigers have an interception. Marcus Christian.
We've got two flags and a hat down, so let's see, might be offsetting.
Marcus Christian has it. And another interception thrown by Reese Davidson.
On the defense. Davidson seems to be bailed out by the penalty. And it looks like Westminster's going to keep the football.
An Iowa Wesleyan defender was saying that Might have been hands to the face.
Looked like hands to the illegal hands to the face during the play by Iowa Wesleyan, and then unsportsmanlike post play by Westminster, which gives Westminster the football at about the same spot as they will offset. Although their referee is doing some wind sprints here, marking everything. So they're going to get the ball at the same spot. Get bailed out from the interception because of a penalty flag mid-play, but then ruined the yardage gained from that penalty with a penalty of their own post-play, but does not cost them the football.
6:51 as the time restarts. Iowa Wesleyan leading 34-6 over Westminster. Aaron Mosier, Hunter Mullahan with you. As Dobbins is lined up behind Davidson, he doesn't get the handoff. It's a pitch to White Robinson. He leaps over a Tiger but fumbles it right into the hands of Sheston. And he is still rumbling at the 30, breaks a tackle on the near side, 25, and eventually dragged out of bounds by Dante Billups. Wyatt Robinson goes from highlight to lowlight as he leaped over a Tiger and then coughed up the football.
Not what you want to see. Got to take care of the football, especially in games where you're not moving the ball as well. And turnovers have been a problem for both sides today, and we've noticed that, but just continues to boil, and it seems as though this might be getting even uglier than it already is. Starting to get see some backups in for Westminster's defense.
Still mostly starters. Some backup wide receivers are in for Iowa Wesleyan as they take over at the 21-yard line. Three wide receivers for Chevalier. Stafford Lewis takes it, and he's met by a pair of Blue Jays after picking up a couple yards.
Now, do you start to see Iowa Wesleyan start to run the ball a little bit more here with under 6.5 to go and a big lead, even though they're really close to their own to the end zone? Do you think that they just keep running the ball, keep running that clock out, and take time away?
Since Cam Cole has scored those couple of touchdowns, it's mostly been Stafford Lewis in as the running back. He takes this handoff as well up the middle and is dragged down after another short pickup. Third down now for Iowa Wesleyan at the 16-yard line. They scored the first two touchdowns of the game in the first off of two beautiful balls by Chevalier to Ferguson. The first one off the crossing pattern, and then Tyler Ball with the catch of the game in the back of the end zone to make it 13-0 in the first quarter. Stafford Lewis again, a gaping hole, and he rumbles into the end zone. Touchdown, Iowa Wesleyan, an impressive run and an impressive push by the offensive line, and then an impressive finish by Stafford Lewis.
Runs over a Westminster defender, knocking his helmet off. A big hit and a big run by Stafford Lewis.
Tigers have eclipsed the 40 mark. And Mosqueda sets up for number 41 as it has been all Iowa Wesleyan in the second half. Kick is through the uprights and Iowa Wesleyan takes the commanding 41-6 lead. We'll be back with more Westminster football. 4:57 remaining. With Westminster trailing 41-6 on their home field. They will not pick up their first win of the season today. They fall to 0-2. Iowa Wesleyan moves to 1-2. Most points on the season through three games for them. And Westminster picks up their first points of the year off of the touchdown to Kelton Virtue. Clap Saddle takes it at the 15-yard line. Breaks outside. Tries to get away from Sheston, who had the fumble recovery on the last Westminster drive, and Clap Saddle is pushed out of bounds.
Wonder if we start to see backups on the offensive side of the ball for Westminster as well, as they had backups in on defense.
Doesn't appear so. Ethan Talour is starting right tackle for them. He's still in.
Looks like the offensive line unit is the same.
But we do see
some backups in on the wide receivers.
Yeah, Aaron Hurt on the near side. I believe that's Aiden Campbell in the slot. Hand off Cole Yancey. No, Davidson keeps option and a pitch to the running back to the far side and pushed out of bounds. Lavelle Whitaker, the sophomore out of Kansas City, Kansas. He's only 5'5", 160. He's pushed out of bounds, getting his first carries of the season. This has been a very, very slow fourth quarter with all the penalties.
Very.
All the turnovers. We're moving at a good pace in the first half. But precipitously, this game has gotten longer and longer.
Four and a half minutes still remain on this clock, and we're moving again for another penalty.
It's now been 3 hours and 5 minutes that we have played. With 4.5 remaining for Westminster. Yancey in the game behind Davidson. Oh, make that a wildcat. And the Westminster Blue Jay holds on to it and runs for a few yards. Kevin Baker, the freshman from just a little bit south in Jefferson City. He kept that one, listed as the fullback. Why not try a few things?
Yeah, maybe try a little bit, maybe a couple different plays that you've been working on in practice. You know, it's a late game. Not a lot to play for. You're playing for pride in this moment. You want to get down and score a touchdown here for the end of the game and make it a little bit closer, but you can't do too much.
Peyton Olson on the near side. He's a wide receiver that's checked in from South Callaway High School.
Wildcat formation here.
Pitch to Whitaker. Whitaker gets outside. A good block by Olson. And Whitaker is out of bounds. They mark him at the 46-yard line. I think that North Callaway High School for Peyton Olson. So Kevin Baker still taking the snaps. And Whitaker shaken up. Will take his leave off the field as he just goes down. As Ben Wallace will check in for him. 2:37 remaining. Iowa Wesleyan with a pretty impressive performance. They made their mistakes as well, but did enough today to get a commanding victory. Baker keeps off tackle and brought down after a short gain on first down. Second down and 7 for the Blue Jays. Again, they take a road trip at Sewanee and then at Rhodes College, at the Rhodes Lynx, and then come back home to face Minnesota Morris on October 1st. First conference game of the year for them. Baker takes the snap, hands it. Nope, keeps it himself. Pitch to Wallace, and he loses the football. Awesome. Recovered by Iowa Wesleyan. And that turnover margin in the favor of the Tigers grows.
Lots of turnovers today from both sides, but Westminster offense just cannot seem to hold on to the football and protect it in the moments that they need it the most.
You have to wonder, what is the locker room conversation, one, after this game, but going into practice next week? I mean, this is – it just was not – there's positive things you can say about the defense, and certainly the offense had its moments, but overall just a very sloppy performance from Westminster.
Very. Defense has played as well as they can with as much as they've been on the field, and now especially with their backups in, you know, you're hoping that maybe you find somebody that is a difference maker and can do something right, even help out that defense that has already been playing very, very sound football.
Surprised to still see offensive starters in for Iowa Wesleyan as Chevalier hands it off to Lewis. I mean, there's plenty of guys on the roster for Coach Daniels to put in, but continue to run Chevalier out there. Mentioned that he replaces Gavin Esquivel. Esquivel was their starter in 2021. But they go to the freshman after Esquivel in 2021. Out of 422 attempts, completed 223, had 2,628 yards, 22 touchdowns, and 15 INTs. But they go to Chevalier, who entered today 20 for 45 and 250 yards passing, 2 touchdowns, no interceptions.
They've taken the delay of game here and then going to kneel the game out.
But
they're going to take a timeout here.
Chevalier did make his mistakes today, but he also had some pretty footballs.
They're going to. Seems like the victory O, based on the sounds of the sideline here, victory O is going to come out.
Credit to most of the fans for staying here today. Haven't seen a lot leave. A lot of parents supporting Westminster football today. We appreciate you tuning in as well on the live stream. We'll be back on October 1st when Westminster hosts Minnesota Morris. They look to try to pick up their first home win of the year right there as they again go on the road for two contests in the next 2 weeks into the South. Chevalier takes the knee, and that does it in Fulton, Missouri, as time winds down. Iowa Wesleyan puts up 41 on Westminster. Westminster kept it close in the first half, but the Tigers came out in the third and fourth quarter and put their foot down. Westminster able to get their first touchdown of the season, their first points of the year in the fourth. As you hear the siren sound and the game is over. Iowa Wesleyan goes back to Mount Pleasant with the victory 41-6 over Westminster. You have been watching Westminster football.